It's prime time at the Georgia Dome for the fifth and final game of the Metro PCS Corky Kell Classic, featuring sixth-ranked McEachern against the Brookwood Broncos, the two teams that started it all 22 years ago. Good evening, everybody. I'm Trey McDaniel alongside my partner in crime, Mr. Keelan Johnson. And Keelan, this should be one heck of a football game here tonight. Two teams with opposing styles. You've got McEachern, who wants to get the ball to their skill guys in space. And then you got Brookwood, who, in typical Brookwood fashion, wants to shove it down your throat. And if Brookwood's going to shove it down their throat, who are they going to do that with tonight, Keelan?
Oh, first and foremost, no other than Josh Brown. This is a great specimen to their wing team offense. He played fullback last year, so he knows all about the grits and the grind and going north-south there, Trey. He's a great player. Like I said, blocks well, and I'm just very anxious to see what he's going to bring to the table this year as the main featured back.
Now we shift gears over to McEachern. McEachern had a lot of success in the regular season. They were unfortunate, although they were just a fourth seed, Colquitt County was. They defeated a number one seed, McEachern, last year, so they've got that sour taste in their mouth.
Yes.
But they've got a quarterback coming back who shared time last year.
Yes.
But right now, it's Ty Clements' time. Talk about the quarterback.
You talk about it's his time, and time is tonight here in the Georgia Dome in the Corky Kell Classic. This is a great player. He can hurt you with his feet, but he also can hurt you with his arm. As you can see him tonight live, right here on GPB, and we're ready to go for it. He had 17 TDs as the last year, and they're ready for him to take the ring as a quarterback and the leader of their team.
It's going to be a fantastic game, a great way to wrap up what has been a phenomenal day of football so far.
Yes.
And we welcome now in the third member of our broadcast team. Let's go down to the sidelines to John Nelson. Nelly, you've been a busy man. What you got for us?
Well, first off, let's see if I have any voice left. Let's talk about a little history here. Let's see, the ninth month of the year would be September. So let's go back to September of 1992 and talk about how the Corky Kell Classic, as it is now known, was the first event ever held in the Georgia Dome. It was only two games back then. It wasn't five. And it had Southwest DeKalb, Noonan, Brookwood, and McEachern. So you had Jimmy Dorsey, Dave Hunter, Max Bass, and Buck Godfrey going at it. And the way that it ended up, first time out of the box, it was a 21-14 win. So Dave Hunter finishes up the season 10-3, Jimmy Dorsey 9-3, a loss for Brookwood against McEachern 21-6. Noonan ended up beating Southwest DeKalb, I want to say 27-6. And the way that the Kell, as it was known now, it was actually just an extra game in the regular season. So you had 11 regular season games for these four teams back in 1992. And I have here some proof that it actually did exist. This was on the uniforms. Now, someone's going to have to talk me through this to make sure that I'm accurate in all of my information. Dome Coming 92 is what it was called back in September. You see the four squads, Noonan, Southwest DeKalb, Brookwood, and McEachern. And I think now that I'm probably going to have to return this to its rightful owner, and there's someone upstairs that, Trey, you know intimately, who I'm going to have to return this to sooner or later. Or either that, or it's going to end up on eBay.
I think I'll find you after the game, John, and get that patch back from you. Yeah, McEachern and Brookwood, really the two teams that started this, thanks to their really historic coaches, Jimmy Dorsey and Dave Hunter. Dave Hunter and Dorsey still spearheading the effort, which is why this game is still going on 22 years later.
Right.
And John gave you all the synopsis from back in 1992. Brookwood loses that game 21-14 to McEachern. They go on to beat them in the playoffs later that year. These two teams, despite their amount of success over the years, have only played each other six other times. This will only be the seventh time that they met. The last time they played in the playoffs in 2009, McEachern was the number one team in the state. Brookwood was a four seed, and they knocked him off, Keelan. Let's go to the Keys to Success, brought to you by the Atlanta Falcons, who remind you to rise up. Keelan?
First and foremost, Brookwood has to get the meat moving up front. They have a new left guard, center, and new right guard. Coaches have to get there, call their number from the jump, right from the start. Secondly, hold their contain on the defense side of the ball. Play sound football, keep their eyes on their reads. That's going to be important for them.
Now we shift over to the McEachern Keys. Take us through the offensive and defensive keys for the Indians.
Like we talk about Ty Clements, first and foremost, he is the key. He has to play a full football game, make the right reads, make and stay poised in the pocket and make the right throws down the field. Secondly, needs to play gap sound football on the defense side of the ball. Hope their offensive line and their DL or Brookwood's OL, whoever is in better shape, will win the football game, because it's going to be a battle in the trenches.
It will be, and it's always a battle of the trenches when you have these two teams who have had a tremendous amount of success over the last three decades. And the McEachern Indians really have a lot on the line, Keelan. This is a team that thought they had the talent to win state last year. They lost three games. Unfortunately for Coach Hockman, he still loves us despite all three of those losses coming on Georgia Public Broadcasting. He is one heck of a football coach. He was the coach at Campbell for a couple seasons. He slipped away, and boy, oh boy, the McEachern Indians in Powder Springs were happy to find him.
Oh, yes. You can tell by just talking to him over the phone, he's excited. He knows he has a great team in front of him, and this is the first game of the year. So a lot of kinks that he needs to work out, but he's putting the ball in his quarterback's hands. He's putting the ball in his team's hands, and this great offensive line. They're very smart up front, so I'm very anxious to see what they bring to the table.
And here you see Coach Cruz and his all-time record at Brookwood. Of course, he's been with Brookwood for 27 years now, was formerly the defensive coordinator. Hard to believe he's been the head coach over there on the sidelines for 12 seasons, a phenomenal record of 104-34, and of course, the state championship a couple years ago over Colquitt County. It looks like McEachern will kick the ball off to Brookwood. McEachern in their home uniforms, dark blue jerseys, and Brookwood in their away uniforms with the white jerseys, both with the gold helmets. And we will prepare in just a few minutes for a moment of silence.
Now, Trey, let's not forget now. You've got to tell the people who are watching here, you was offensive lineman for them.
We're going to have a brief moment of silence, which we have had before each game in memory of the Creekside player killed in a scrimmage last week, defensive back DeAndre Tourman. Our thoughts and prayers go out to the young man, his family, and the Creekside community.
Tourman, our prayers and love go to his family, friends, school, and community. Let's take a moment of silence to reflect on DeAndre Tourman.
Set to begin the fifth and final game of the 2013 Metro PCS Corky Kell Classic as McEachern gets set to kick off. Kicking off is number 16 junior Dennis Dominguez. Back deep to receive is Patrick Mills for Brookwood. Mills takes it at his own 15-yard line, has a seam, gets past the 30-yard line. He's brought down just shy of the 35, and Brookwood will start first down and 10 to start their 2013 campaign. And coming out to lead the Brookwood Broncos is senior Joey McLean. Much like the Grayson situation, if you recognize the name McLean, his brother Ben was the quarterback for the 2010 Brookwood Broncos when they won the state championship. This is his younger brother, 6 foot, 180 pounds, replaces the two-year starter Zach Moon. And he did see some playing time last year, 4-14 for 65 yards, no touchdowns. Brookwood will be in a offset eye formation for most of the game. Two receivers this time split out wide to the right. On the first play, tight end Sweeney moves from left to right. And we'll get a false start on the first play of the game as Josh Brown, the guy that Keelan spotlighted to start the game, comes out of his stance prematurely.
Hey, the first snap of the season, I'm sure he has a little jitterbugs in his belly.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense, 5 yards, first down.
You see our officials for the game. And you think Mr. Brown might have been getting the ball right there?
There's no doubt in my mind he was getting the ball there, Trey. It's very interesting to see how this team's going to come out and how they're going to attack this aggressive defensive line.
So a penalty on the very first play from scrimmage. And they'll come right back out, first down at 15. Ball at the 29-yard line. McLean gives it to Brown, right side. Got a good initial block, but unable to get past the second wave of defenders. Glenn Frazier on the tackle, and here's our Regions Bank starting lineup for Brookwood. You see Miguel Herrera, Nick Coker, and Ivan Meyer. They'll be running behind those guys all night long. The skill position players for Brookwood: Josh Brown, Matt Price, Sweeney, Allen, and Collins.
Keep your eye out for Matt Price. Coach, I have him as Mr. Dependable. He does a little bit of everything for this ball club.
So after the 2 yard gain on first down by Brown, second down, about 13 yards to go. Man in motion, play action here on second down. And it's Keenan Sweeney, the tight end at the 50-yard line, and rumbling out of bounds at the McEachern 40. And a late hit, they'll tack on 15 yards. A huge play for Brookwood on second down and long. 29-yard pitch and catch from McClain to Sweeney.
Nice tight end pop pass. You see this play action. He waits on him, you see him in the seam. Hey, the defenders have their eyes in the backfield. Nice catch by Keenan Sweeney, coming off a knee surgery. Nice play by Keenan.
Glenn Frazier making his second tackle.
Coach mentioned about Keenan, he had really good hands.
Personal foul on the defense, 15 yards, first down.
So after the penalty, it'll be first down and 10 from the McEachern 25-yard line. First big play of the game, thanks in part to the penalty. And they'll go left side, penetration, and tackled for a loss is Josh Brown. Let's take a look at the starting lineup for the McEachern defense, brought to you by Regions Bank. Billingsley and Henry Fumura will anchor the defensive line for the Indians. They've got a lot of speed in the backfield. There you see Glenn Frazier, who's already made a couple of tackles here in the first possession.
Keep your eye on Christian Wade, the leader and the heart and soul of this defense. He's the rah-rah guy. Coach really, really likes him. He keeps everybody motivated.
You see Darius Thompson there. He'll be the deep guy on defense as Josh Brown gingerly coming off the field after the tackle for loss. He got spun around a little bit, Keelan, and then hit square as he was dropped for the loss.
Yeah,
and that's not a good sign for the Broncos.
Not a good sign at all, but you have to give credit to this defensive line up front. These guys up front who runs this 4-3 even front. They're giving a lot of penetration in the backfield and running plays.
Offset eye formation behind McClain this time, a receiver to each side on second and long. And it's a dive play, cut up inside, and a first down. Carrying the ball for Brookwood was number 29, Joshua Collins, the junior.
As you see, it's a simple trap play coming up. Reed made a nice read. You got to point out to this offensive line. You got to look at this hole that he's coming through there as he sees the safety come up and make an open field tackle. As you see that trap right there. That's a great run by the junior.
Collins having to fill in for Brown. Collins normally just the fullback, doesn't get a lot of carries, but he made the most of his first one. First down and 10, just outside the 10-yard line. They can't pick up a first down without scoring, and they'll blow this one dead before it starts.
The leg game. Offense, 5-yard penalty. It remains first down.
Boy, that is a killer after a big play. You're getting down deep into the Regions Bank red zone, and you get a penalty, a very avoidable penalty, a delay a game.
Yes. It just, you know, like I said, everything's about timing. Routes is about timing. Coaches getting the plays to the players is about timing. Getting out of the hole is about timing. It's first game of the season. I'm sure they're going to work on this one.
And since Josh Brown went out of the game, Nick Aubie has filled in as the deep back. He's normally a defensive back, but here having to fill in a tailback. And they'll blow it dead once again. Penalty ridden first.
Yes.
2 minutes and 10 seconds of this football game.
Two plays in a row. There was delay of game right there, Trey. I'm sure the coach is going to take full responsibility for
this. Delay game, offense, 5-yard penalty. It remains first down.
Let's go downstairs and get an injury update on Josh Brown from John Nelson. Nelly.
Thank you, Trey. Here's your update. He just got hit hard when he turned the wrong way. He's answering the questions all the right way, shaking it off. He'll be back. No worries.
It's just the cobwebs down there, John. That's all it is.
That's all it is. Just a cobweb.
We're going to have some after today. three penalties for 15 yards to start the game for Brookwood. And again, another penalty. Actually, this will be a timeout for Brookwood. So delay of game.
Timeout. Brookwood.
And you see, this time it's Mark Cruz coming out to talk to the team. Sometimes you send an assistant out. You get a delay of game and a delay of game back-to-back inside the red zone, first possession of your season against a quality team. The coach got to settle these boys down.
You know, you play for this coach, right, Trey?
Indeed.
And I'm just looking at his face. What is something that you played offensive line? What is something he's going to tell you?
Well, I played defensive line, but he was my defensive coordinator at Brookwood. And Coach Cruz has a unique ability to cut through the baloney and get right to the point. And that's what he's doing down there. He's telling these guys, they started the game well. Don't shoot yourself in the foot. You're going to have limited opportunities to make hay against this defense. You've got an opportunity here. Don't blow it. We need every point we can get.
There's someone who's been in that huddle right there.
Let's take a look now at Brookwood's resume. We talked about three decades of success that begun under Coach Dave Hunter, state championships in 1996, 2010, five-time state finalists, first time all the way back in 1988, nine region championships, made the playoffs, Keelan, 24 of the last 26 years, and of course, the guy that makes this game happen, the Kell Classic, the executive director of that, Dave Hunter, who was 105-36 in his coaching career.
That is a stat that I really like with that, 24 out of 26 times. That's a major stat there, Trey.
All right, toss sweep, right side, Brown's back in the game, and he gets a few yards, crossed back into the red zone after the two penalties before he's taken down by McKinsley Billingsley, the defensive end from McEachern, number 98.
It's good to see Josh Brown back out there running north-south. And that's their mojo. You know, you have a second and long. You got to stick with what's working, and what's working for them right now. It's misdirectional running plays, and I'm sure Josh Brown is going to have his share tonight.
So on second and long, McLean will be in the shotgun with Brown standing to his left. He'll air it out here on second down. It's a bit high. Over top of wide receiver senior number 83, Grant Hill. Way too tall for Hill, and it falls incomplete.
Yeah, McLean just let that ball sail on him. He dropped his elbow a little bit. His feet wasn't settled. Sometimes that happens when you have a young quarterback like Joey McLean.
So third down and long, well, they're definitely within range of their field goal kicker, Brandon Morrow, is preseason All-State. But you know the coaching staff over there for Brookwood really wants to get 7 points. So third down here, I would expect going to the air.
You have no choice. Look for it. This is a high intensity of screen down right here.
There you see McLean. He's got all kinds of time, and he lets it sail once again. And he's lucky to have it not picked off. As number 8, Darius Thompson, the free safety, goes up and almost picks that ball off. And what it'll do for Brookwood is it'll at least preserve an opportunity to kick a field goal here on fourth down.
Oh, it just hit his hands. One thing a defensive back coach is going to say, catch the ball, young fella. Catch the ball.
The old saying, if you can touch it, you can catch it.
That's right.
And Morrow checks in to attempt his first field goal of the season. It'll be a 36-yard attempt from the far right hash to take the lead. Good snap, and it's up and good, and Brookwood strikes first blood here on the first possession of the game. And we'll take a quick break with 8:53 left to go in the first quarter. In game 5 of the Metro PCS Corky Kell Classic, Brookwood leads 6th-ranked McEachern by a score of 3-0 right here on GPB.
I'm Mike Laverty, Regional Marketing Director for Metro PCS. We're proud to be the title sponsor of the Metro PCS Corky Kell Classic. It truly is the standard in high school football, like our nationwide 4G network is in wireless technology. Our partnership is just one of the many ways that Metro PCS gives back to the communities we serve. We appreciate your support and are thrilled that Georgia Public Broadcasting will be televising all these great games across the state of Georgia. Thank you.
Live at the Georgia Dome. Game 5 of the Corky Kell Classic next week. It's the All Access Pass live from Grayson High School as the North Gwinnett Bulldogs take on the Grayson Rams in our first installment of Football Fridays in Georgia. Yeah. There's no other place I'd rather be, Keelan.
We're going to be right here in the booth with me and you, boss, man. I can't wait. The one thing I just want to point out here is 8 plays, 47 yards, and the time of possession. They're not 3 minutes and 7 seconds off the clock. That is a nice scoring drive. Nice scoring drive.
Scoring drive brought to you by the Technical College System of Georgia, one of our great partners and sponsors here on Georgia Public Broadcasting. As Brookwood gets set to kick off, back deep to receive is Alize Chubb and Taj Griffin. Taking it to 1 yard line by Ryan Sherman, the deep guy. And he stumbles ahead to the 26-27 yard line, and that's where the Indians will set up shop for the first time in the 2013 campaign. First and 10 from there as they trot out the quarterback. Number 2, the guy that you spotlighted, Keelan, Ty Clemens, was in a rotation at quarterback last year with the senior Ty Griffin, Taj's older brother, and now Clemens is the man. He's one of the most versatile players in all of the state, and they're putting a lot on his shoulders because he's got a lot of weapons, but he's the guy that has to distribute the ball to him.
Yeah, we talked to his coach, and his coach says he's lying a little bit beneath the radar because he only played in a few games last year. You know, 7 touchdowns last year, but now this is his team. He's the leader. Everything is in his hands.
And for the first time tonight, they hand it to Taj Griffin, one of the best-kept secrets in football. And let's take a look at our Regions Bank starting lineup for the McEachern Indians. Take a look at number 77, Chuma Edoga. He's the guy they're going to run behind most frequently, the offensive tackle, number 77, just a junior, big-time SEC. Looks Taj Griffin, who just carried the ball, number 7. He is a phenomenal player for McEachern. He will get upwards of 15 to 20 touches here tonight. A little misdirection, play action pass. It's Alize Chubb in the flat, 30, 35, 40 yard line, and a first down for McEachern.
Nice movement by Ty, by keeping this play alive. Defensive end coming up and almost sacking him, and he throws that ball. You can see some of his athleticism. He throws the ball kind of sideways. As you pay attention, there's a bleep replay right here. Nice play action. He goes to the side to keep this play alive, to keep the chains moving.
Nice pitch and catch for 13 yards in the first down of the game for McEachern. And they turn around and give it to Taj Griffin. Look at him on the outside. He's the fastest guy on the team. One guy to beat. 25, 20, 15, and out of bounds. Big first down for McEachern. And you see why Taj Griffin is one of the best kept secrets in Georgia high school football. He found a 6th gear right there, Keelan.
Oh, man, I saw this play develop from as soon as he handed him the ball. Look at the edge right there, the seam off the corner. Ah, that speed there, man, that is pure speed.
Take a look at the schools that are after this young man. He's just a junior. That's a who's who of college football as they give it to Ryan Sherman up the middle. He's got a host of blockers, and Nick Obie can't take him down. It's a touchdown, McEachern. And just like that, this quick strike offense for the Indians shows you why they're the 6th ranked team in the land. Touchdown, McEachern, 14 yards.
Trey, you talk about north-south football. This is just smash mouth football here, straight out of the pistol, straight power. Oh, tackles pulling, guards pulling. Great run by Sherman, by Ryan Sherman. Played in a few games last year. Now it seems like this is his team as well.
Well, last year he was a bruising back, but he played behind his big brother.
I'm glad he's probably glad his big brother's moved on about his business.
PAT up and good. McEachern answers back, and they answer back in a big way. Take a look at our TCSG touchdown replay. Keelan, take us through.
Look at this down south. He's getting behind the meat up front. He's keeping those feet moving, keeping those legs turning. Those squats are finally playing off on there, Sherman. That's one thing. His vision. Most running backs have a tendency to get hit the first time and fall. Sherman kept his eyes up, kept his feet moving. He protected the ball, most importantly, and he got across the goal line. Coach is happy about this running back here.
And I tell you what, if he gets 6 points, you should give 3 of those to left tackle senior Uche Nkati. He picked up the young man and carried him in the end zone. Here you see the scoring drive, only a minute, 10 seconds, 4 plays, 74 yards, most of it on the long run there on the second play from scrimmage by Taj Griffin.
This is very interesting. This offense has so much to offer. They have a very, very balanced running attack, and they have a balanced passing attack. And not only look at this big fella right here sitting on the bench with a smile
you
on his face.
Kidding. He's just a junior, too.
Wow.
An embarrassment of riches up in Powder Springs. A lot of guys at the skill position, sometimes, what do you call them, the meat up front? Sometimes those guys get lost in the shuffle. Not on that play.
No, not one bit.
Dennis Dominguez set to kick off from McEachern. Lands down at the 24-yard line for a fair catch. And that's where Brookwood will set up shop. They've got to answer back. I mean, they had to feel victorious getting 3 points on the first down, but a minute, 10 seconds later, you're behind.
That's right. It just speaks on a specimen of the playmakers they have around their football team.
Let's check in downstairs with John Nelson. Nelly, what you got?
I don't know what it is with me and running backs tonight. Ryan Sherman, you saw him kind of grabbing the right-hand side of his rib cage. If you look at the replay, he landed on the football. And that's how he ended up a little dinged. And so, obviously, he'll be okay and go back in, but he's got to gather it a little bit. But everything's cool so far.
Thanks for the update, Nelly. I did not see that. No gain or possibly a loss of one. Tackled by Cameron McGee. Josh Brown on the carry. Looks like Josh Brown showing no ill effects from what you call the cobwebs on the sideline after the first series. He's right back at it.
Yeah, that's what you want to see from your senior running back there. He knows he has to be on this football field and to keep the chains moving to give his team a chance in the dome tonight.
Grant Hill checking in from the sideline, delivering the play to Joy McClain and the Brookwood Broncos on second down and 11 from the 23-yard line. Offset I formation behind McClain. It's another play action pass on second down and long, and he gets outside the pocket thanks to a hold. This one's going to come back. It's a pitch and catch to number 85 Mike Allen, but it's going to be coming back because of the hold.
It's just these flags.
There was no mistake in this one.
You kind of see Joey McClain get out the lane and try to make something happen with his feet, and he gets the completion, and then once again Brookwood backing him up because of a penalty. As you see there, left tackle just holding the defensive end on the end there. Harvey.
Number 74, Griffin Perkins on the hold. And he kept his quarterback upright, but he was penalized for it. So what was second down and long?
Holding on the offense, half the distance to the goal, second down.
It is now second down and an eternity for Brookwood. Brown remains in as the deep back behind McClain. And first man through gets the ball. I believe that's up man Josh Collins. And he may have picked up a yard. Making the tackle for McEachern is number 99, Julian Rochester.
We've seen a lot of penalties in today's games. When you talk about the first games, you're going to have to get some of those mistakes out the way.
First game jitters.
You're going to have to get that out the way. A lot of these coaches today will have a lot of coaching points for game film this week.
McClain in the shotgun has to pick up a lot of yards on third down and very long, and he'll just escape with his life out of bounds around the 15-yard line. A legal hit knocks him all the way over to the Corky Kell banner on the far sideline, and Brookwood will have to punt for the first time tonight.
Just tremendous speed by the D lineman and the linebackers coming off and forcing a really good fourth down. Brookwood 4 for 24 yards and penalties. McEachern 1 for 15 tonight. Penalties can come back to haunt you, I'm telling you, Trey.
T.J. Romming back deep to receive for McEachern, and here's another pre-snap penalty. All right, and they ask him to wind the clock and move ahead. And I say, thank you. a bad punt. Goes out of bounds somewhere between the 25 and the 35-yard line. The punter there is senior Grant Hill, who also serves as a wide receiver for this football team. And if I'm not mistaken, there's another piece of laundry on the field down here, Keelan, on the near side at the 22.
Yes, sir. It looks like somebody's dirty laundry out there. Oh, it's the ref's dirty laundry.
That'll be a hold on McEachern. Hockman getting an explanation from one of his assistant coaches as we await them to mark off the penalty. And now Coach Cruz getting an explanation from the officials as well on the far sideline as to exactly what happened and what the result will be for the Broncos offense.
Holding on the receiving team 10 yards from the end of the kick. First down.
And that is a automatic first down for the Brookwood Broncos. Wow.
You sit there trying to. Yeah, I can't quite see it there, but.
Now it looks like Brookwood has their defensive unit on the field.
Right.
So they're going to call holding during the kick.
Okay.
So it'll actually be first down and 10 McEachern inside Brookwood territory at the 41-yard line. That was confusing, but I think we got it all sorted out. First and 10 McEachern. And we'll have a false start and another penalty.
Prior to snap, have false start on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
So far, Keelan, we've seen a game's worth of penalties here.
Yes.
In about 6 minutes and 20 seconds.
Right, right. And like I said, both of these teams are still trying to get the game vibe and trying to get the pace going. And, you know, and the coaches are trying to get the rhythm of how the players are.
Clemens, nice pass. T.J. Romney, he's going to go to the house, but there's another flag on the field.
Nice pass by Ty Clemens there. But unfortunately, it is coming back. Something quick, something high percentage throw right there. Receiver come on out and, yep, he blocked him in the back.
That's tight end Trey Scott on Nick Aubie. He took him right out of the play. It would have been a beautiful block if he had him heads up, but instead of blocking the back, and a touchdown comes off the board.
Trey, you can really see how versatile this McEachern offense is. They can hurt you at any hat of the dime. That was one of my keys. You have to pay attention to your keys on the defense side of the ball if you're Brookwood. That is a prime example. If it wasn't for a penalty, that is 6 on the scoreboard.
It's a spot of the foul, so they'll mark the ball back around the 46-yard line. It will remain first down, but it'll be first down and 15 yards from that spot.
Illegal block in the back on the offense. 10-yard penalty. Replay first down.
And you can really feel, Keelan, the energy just getting sucked out of the dome. The crowd, the teams, the guys in the press box. It's just not a lot of life right here.
Right.
Some big plays have happened, but the penalties have really killed the vibe here at the Georgia Dome so far in the early going.
One thing my coach always used to tell us as a team, don't shoot yourselves in the foot. And that's exactly what McEachern is doing right
Number
now.
Number 71, Uche Nkati just jumped offsides once again on what was first down and 20. And this will push the ball back into McEachern territory. The drive started around the Brookwood 40.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense, 5-yard penalty. It remains first down.
Now, if I'm Ty Clemens, if I'm the quarterback and I'm the leader of this team, I'm whispering to every single person in the huddle. I'm talking to my offensive linemen. I'm talking to my running backs. And you have to get these guys under control. You have to give them some type of encouragement so you can get back to playing football.
Pistol formation for the Indians and another pre-snap flag. And now the boos from the crowd start to rain out from the McEachern side. And the foul will be on the Indians.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense, 5-yard penalty.
10 penalties. McEachern, 6 for 50. Brookwood 4-for-29.
Keelan, we're halfway, just over halfway through the first quarter. If this continues, we're going to be here until next Friday. Yeah. We're supposed to be in Grayson.
Yeah, we we'll have to push that game back. That's right.
Give up the middle. Griffin, nice move to get to the 48-yard line. It'll be nowhere near enough for a first down, but it's a nice chunk of yardage on first down that gets him back close to midfield again. And you can see how dynamic this young man is with the ball in his hand.
If you see Antonio Valentine making a pull from his right guard position to open up the lane for him right there, he's driving right off his right shoulder. That just lets you know this offense can score any given moment. They can get a first down anytime they want, but they really have to play under control in order for this offense to work.
Give up the middle. Breaking into Brookwood territory once again is McEachern. They'll still be well short of a first down. This will bring up third down and very long. And at this point on the field and with what has happened, and you've got a third down and long play, you've got relatively good field position and all these weapons, you go conservative here or you take a shot?
You might want to go conservative. It's still early. You know, McEachern still has the momentum a little bit. But this to talk about the feelings that McEachern has. A bold ball coach once told me the game of football is 90% mental, 10% physical, because everybody can hit hard, everybody can run fast, but not everyone can play discipline.
Two-step drop, a pass, it's tipped. T.J. Robbing still could have had it, but drops it. Nick Albee on the coverage. That was a nice, crisp pass by Clemens, and Raymond is unable to bring it in.
Ty Clemens back there. The outside linebacker there comes on up and he extends and keep his hands up high to bat the ball down and made a very hard catch for T.J. Ramey.
I would say Brookwood forces a punting situation, Keelan, but really it was McEachern's own offense that forced this fourth down and punt. Dennis Dominguez kicking the ball away from McEachern. It's a high wobbly kick. And it's not fair caught, but dropped at the 17-yard line, and a huge break for McEachern. So after all the penalties, they get the ball right back inside the red zone with a chance.
That's a great heads-up play by the gunner there. You never know how that ball's going to pop out. That's why they corral around the ball and they make sure that they pay attention to the punt returner, because he may make a mistake. And that's just a great heads-up play.
That was wide receiver Mike Allen back deep to receive the punt. So some special teams gaffes for Brookwood. A very short punt on their last possession, and now they fail to receive one cleanly. And the offense, this dynamic offense for the Indians, takes the field once again.
Great heads-up play by Andrew Hayward. I want to make sure I give him credit. That's a great job by the gunner getting down there, giving the punt returner some space, because you also, it's a halo rule. You have to make sure you give him a yard so he can catch the ball. But great heads up play by him.
Play action. Clemens showing good footwork, has a couple lanes, still looking downfield, wanting to throw. Now he'll turn upfield inside the 10 and inside the 5, and he dives for the pylon and doesn't quite get it. It'll be first down and goal. McEachern, and a late flag comes in. It might be a late hit for Brookwood, although the offensive linemen for McEachern are awfully upset. This one may be against the Indians. Let's take a look.
Hey, offensive lineman downfield. This is a great way by Ty, just keeping the play alive with his feet. Like I told you, he can hurt you with his feet, and he definitely hurt you with his arm. You're going to see the effort that he has. He's just selling out, trying to get to the pylon.
And with all the confusion early, both coaches, both Cruz and Hockman, are demanding that the officials come over and explain to them exactly what the infraction is, just in case the coaches suspect that they may be a little flag happy here early. But I'll give credit to the officials. They are not flag happy. What they're throwing the flags on are perfectly legit. These are mistakes.
It's definitely legit. And Trey, you know, this
after the play was over, have personal foul on the offense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Talk about shooting yourself in the foot. You struggle with the penalties. You make a great special team play. You try to get the momentum back. Then the very next play, you go down here, and you have a keep your play alive by your leader of your team, and then someone go ahead and make a bonehead decision to hit a personal foul at the end of the run.
Pistol formation for Clemens. He gives it to Griffin, and Griffin is stood up at the 15-yard line. Nick Albee making the tackle there with a little help from middle linebacker Hobie McLean, and a nice play by the middle linebacker for Brookwood to hem in a very dangerous player.
I just want to just state that is a great open field tackle by Nick Obby. He's their go-to guy. Good player. Coaches love him. He does everything the coaches ask him to do. And he said, hey, when your number's called, he's always available for him. So great open field tackle by the cornerback.
Three receivers this time for McEachern split out to the left. And looks like Williams is going to call his own number and pull it out of the belly of Griffin, and he's taken down on the outside. Some of the fans wanted a horse collar, but they don't get it. It's a phenomenal tackle for Brookwood on the outside. Let's check out the replay. Nice spin move initially, and again, another open field tackle made by number 23. That's Kevin Knight, who's made a couple nice tackles here in the early going, and they wanted a horse collar there, but they didn't get it.
As you can see how versatile Ty is by just making sure he can keep the play alive and spinning out of the pocket and keeping body control. That's something you can't coach. Either you're born with it or you're not.
True shotgun here for Clemens, who rolls out to his right. And he had a receiver out there who was bracketing. Looks, that's Elijah Van Dorn, and a dangerous pass. Luckily, it was a little bit higher. It probably would have been picked off by Nick Obby.
That's another great defensive play. Ball in the air, ball thrown up. Cornerback just breaking on the ball and knocking it down.
Dennis Dominguez will check in now for a would-be field goal for the Indians, and Brookwood's defense and defensive coaching staff has to be happy after the miscue on special teams to be able to force a field goal attempt for the Indians. They'll put the tee down at the 22-yard line, so it'll be a 32-yard field goal for the left-footed kicker, Dennis Dominguez. He's got the distance, and he splits the uprights, and McEachern adds to their lead as they go up 10-3 with just 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go in the first quarter. Feels like it should be the third quarter right now, but with all the penalties, it's been a slow moving first quarter. But you've seen when they don't shoot themselves in the foot, McEachern has a pretty good offense.
Sure, I have to admit, you know, just starting this first quarter off with all the penalties, for them to have 10 points on the board, that is still a good first half. 10-3, you gotta give it back to them. 5 plays on this drive, 2 yards, 1 minute and 45 seconds off the clock they drink. That's just a great job by the offense. You always want to get in the red zone. You always want to score, and they accomplished their goal tonight. 5 plays, 2 yards. 5 plays, 2 yards there, Trey. The most important thing, 1 minute and 45 seconds off the clock.
But they get points, and that's all that matters. And all of our scoring drives throughout the season will be brought to you by the Technical College of System of Georgia. Remind you to learn more and earn more. This kick is handled cleanly at the 32-yard line, and the returner gets absolutely hammered by Alizé Chubb. It'll be first down and 10 from that point. Take a look at some big plays here, Keelan.
It actually been some big plays going on in this game. Brookwood coming down, having a nice tight end pop pass right there by the tight end, and also the next play to get the field goal. Coming back out with Mr. Dependable, one of the fastest guys I've seen in the state of Georgia with my own personal eyes. Coming down the field with a nice north-south run. Hard touchdown run. And then special teams. You cannot forget about special teams. That's one of the most important plays in the game of football. And then there you go, right here. Ty Clemens making it happen with his feet. And that set up the field goal.
First play from scrimmage on this possession. Brookwood tries the right side of the offensive line and the short side of the field. It's the usual suspect. Josh Brown on the carry. He'll go down for no gain. And Brookwood's offense will undoubtedly try to get their run game going, Keelan.
Yeah, you got to get the run game going. You got to stick to what you know. You got to get Josh Brown a couple of touches. And also, you also got to make sure to keep this defense honest. They know Josh Brown's going to touch the ball, but you have to put the ball in somebody else's hands. Try throwing the ball on a nice out, something safe. Get your quarterback in the rhythm. Get him going, because right now Brookwood is not sticking to anything they know right now. Another flag. Story about life.
Play a game. Offense, 5-yard penalty. second half.
That is the third delay of game here in the first quarter for Brookwood, and Coach Cruz is all the way out almost to the hash mark, screaming at his offense, wanting him to get the play in and get the ball snapped. What Brookwood does between every play, Keelan, is they'll send a wide receiver normally in with the play, and they're just not efficient doing that right now. Brown, five rushes for no yards here in the first quarter as Brookwood trying to get something going on offense. Play action pass, McClain nowhere to throw, runs into his own guy, finds a little bit of a seam and goes down at the 30-yard line after a gain of a couple. It'll still bring up third down and long for the Broncos.
To be honest with you there, Trey, on that, the offensive tackle and the offensive guards across the board, Joey Lane, he had time. You just call that is just straight a coverage sack. Secondary doing the things they're supposed to do. Kiddos to this McEachern defense, because you know what? When the quarterback doesn't have options, you have to give credit to the secondary.
Offensive lineman down for the Broncos. That's number 68, left guard junior Bailey Ivemeyer, 6'2", 240 pounds. Take a look here at some Brookwood Broncos notable players from the past, and there's been several of them. And Keelan, you may have even played with a couple of these guys.
Oh yeah, man. I'll be honest with you, Brookwood Hall of Fame. One guy I played with who was something that was very high energy. I'm just going to continue to talk about him from Brookwood. It's Rennie Kern. A really personal good friend of mine, high energy guy. He always had a nose for the football, and he's just a light character type person, man. Kiddos to him, he's playing Canadian League right now, and he's a hard hitter too, man. That's one thing that Rennie was. He was definitely a hammer. He was definitely wasn't a nail. He was a hammer.
Remember him making a big play against South Carolina down at the goal line.
Yes, sir. Fumble. Yes, sir.
So after Ivemeyer gets taken off the field, play resumes. It's third down and a long 12 from the 29-yard line. Shotgun formation, the back to either side for McClain. They go out and pass routes. McClain looking over the middle, has a guy. It's Mike Allen. First down, Brookwood at the 47-yard line. Mike Allen redeeming himself, so to speak. He was the one that dropped that punt earlier in the game, and here he comes up with a big pass reception and a big first down.
A talented kid. Look at this route. The route very nice and crisp. Quarterback scrambling a little bit. He continues to run through his route. Coach loves his hands. He's a great kid. He's very talented. That's one thing that coaches, they are very high on this wide receiver. And hey, they're going to need more plays like this from Mr. Allen.
17-yard first down reception for Allen. McClain again passing on first down, and almost a nice one-handed catch by Josh Brown, who lined up at the flanker position on that one. It'll be second down and long, and I like what they're doing here. Exactly what you said, Keelan. Go off script a little bit, throw in an unpredictable situation.
Oh, he just couldn't get his hands on this ball. I thought he almost had it. It was very close from getting picked off by the defensive end, McKenzie. But yeah, they have to get this defense on their heels a little bit. They know what's going to happen. They know Brookwood's going to run the ball. But hey, that's what they game plan for.
Here on second down and 10, shotgun formation. Brown the deep back. He goes out in a route here in the flat, but McClain gets flushed from the pocket to the right, goes across his body and looking for Allen again, and it falls incomplete. Defending on the play, number 53, junior Will linebacker Christian Wade.
You got a big third down coming up here. As you see, Joey getting out of the pocket just doesn't have anybody open. Once again, that's just a great coverage sack by this defense.
So after the long play to Mike Allen on third down and very long, Brookwood finds themselves once again on their side of the field, third down and long at the 45-yard line. They trail in this one 10-3 with 19 seconds to go here before the end of the first quarter. Back to pass again is McClain. Got a man. It's Allen. He drops it at the 47. And there's a penalty down. Might be roughing the passer, which would be a 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Yeah.
I believe the pressure there was by defensive end, the senior Henry Femora, the Louisville commit, might have committed a 15-yarder, and he did. I believe this actually might be going against Brookwood. The flag went down right where Femora struck McClain, and I saw Femora talking to the official. But it's actually holding on Brookwood.
Now let's see what they come out and do.
Holding on the offense, the penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Hockman declines the penalty to put Brookwood in fourth and long. It's a punting situation. Here's a good shot of the hold, Keelan.
All right, as you can tell, number 74 right there. Left tackle, Griffin, just totally uncalled for. Hands on the outside of the shoulder pads, you cannot. As an offensive lineman, it's very important for you to get your hands on the inside. As you know, you play defensive line. You know when the offensive lineman get his hands underneath those shoulder pads, it's absolutely nothing
it's
you
game,
can do.
It's game over.
Game is over.
Brookwood punting now. Rahming back deep to receive, standing at his 14. A much better punt this time for Grant Hill. And it's taken by Rahming. He's breaking ankles and more flags down on the field as he goes down at the 25-yard line. A phenomenal initial move. Let's check the flag. A 40-yard punt for Brookwood. This will be a block in the back if you can read his lips. It'll be against McEachern once again.
Wow.
And you said something earlier, Keelan, about, I'll use the word punishment.
Oh, yeah.
When you played for Georgia.
Oh, yes.
And the punishment you guys received as a team.
As a team.
When your team was penalty laden during a game. I think some of these boys might be running some steps next week over at McEachern High School, and they've got one of the biggest stadiums in the state, so it's going to be a tough task.
We might need to get the cameraman from the studios to come check that one out. But, yeah, that is something you have to be able to hold your team accountable for their mistakes. Now, there's too many mistakes in the first quarter. You just cannot have it. This is something that you definitely want to nip in the bud. It's because it's a long season. You cannot be a playoff caliber type team.
During the return, I have an illegal block in the back on the return team. It's 10 yards from the spot. We'll have one untimed down.
So it's
first down.
0-0-0 on the clock, but they'll have one untimed down here before these two teams switch ends of the field. And after the penalty, it'll be first down and 10 on the change of possession. McEachern will take it at their own 10.
Like I was saying about the penalties, you have to hold them accountable, because this is a long season, Trey, and you want to make sure you nip it in the bud from the jump. There it is right there. 6 on Brookwood, 44 yards. McEachern 7 and 65 yards. Penalties, penalties, penalties. And this is just the end of the first quarter.
Pistol for Clemens. He takes no drop. He fires it. Looking for Raymond on the 20-yard line. And we're going to take a break here as that play ends the first quarter. It's been an eventful one. It's been a frustrating one because of all the penalties. But right now, McEachern's got to be happy with a 10-3 lead over Brookwood. This is the fifth and final game of the Corky Kell Classic at the Dome on GPB.
Atlanta Falcons fans, it has been confirmed. The local rally cry, Rise Up, has spread like kudzu over Atlanta and into outlying areas. We are in the advanced stages of the Rise Up epidemic. It is airborne now. There is no cure, and it is highly contagious.
Team is not something you do alone. Team is plural. Team is arms, legs, blood, sweat, and soul. A lot goes into team. But what we take away stays with us. Forever.
You might be surprised to learn who has IBD. Nearly 1 in 200 Americans suffer with the debilitating pain and constant disruption of inflammatory bowel disease. The toll is both physical and emotional. Chances are you know someone with IBD. Someone like me.
I'm Amy Brenneman, and I support the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation of America. CCFA was created to help those with IBD cope and to find a cure. People with IBD can't wait. Won't you help someone you know?
Touchdown. Are you willing to give a helping hand? Enter GPB's video contest. Win $1,000 and make a difference.
Sorry.
How can you help stop the drop?
Back at the Georgia Dome, 10-3 McEachern, and down to the sideline to our social media correspondent, Grace Olson. Grace, good evening.
Good evening, Trey. Hey, all you football experts watching at home. I'm standing here with John Nelson.
Beauty and the Beast.
Football expert himself. Now, I've been talking on social media, on Twitter and on Facebook, about these teams with all of you fans. And boy, do you know the game. Now, we want to know, for tonight's trivia question, the last one of the day, which of these teams, Brookwood or McEachern, played the first ever football game in the Georgia Dome? Not the first ever high school game. The first football game in the Georgia Dome. Tweet me or Facebook me with your answer. I'll reveal the winner in the fourth quarter. And let's go back to the game.
Second down and 10 here for the McEachern Indians to start the second quarter. Give Taj Griffin up the middle, splits the defenders. Ladies and gentlemen, he might be gone. 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, McEachern. Taj Griffin, 90 yards.
Oh, my goodness. This guy is just continually just to keep impressing me. Look at the move he's put on the outside safety there. And it's to the house. Look at the form there, Trey. You can tell this guy's a track guy. Doesn't look back. Pure, raw talent. He's going to make somebody a very, very, very proud teammate next year.
And a flag on the PAT. Griffin now 7 carries for 152 yards. And that was the first play of the second quarter.
90 yards to the house.
Let's check the flag.
Prior to the snap, have encroachment on defense, half the distance. We'll have a try.
Maybe Brookwood wanted to get even. We saw the graphic. They had one less penalty than McEachern, so now they've evened things up.
Yes.
Dominguez will attempt the point after to try to extend McEachern's lead to 17-3 with 11:43 to go before the half.
Taj Griffin, his coach has mentioned he loves life. He loves football. He loves his teammates. He makes everybody better around him. As you can tell, his teammates are out front blocking for him. There's a great block by the receiver, Mr. Williams, the senior. He brings this team together, and that's why I think this kid is going to be something special for years to come in the next level of D1 football.
You know, Kevin Knight did all he could to try to turn him inside where he had help. But when the help can't catch the guy carrying the ball, there's nothing he can do. 90 yards to the house. And this guy, I don't like to throw out comparisons too lightly, but when I saw this young man last year when GPB did the Battle of the Big Chicken up in Powder Springs at McEachern, and I saw him play against Walton, he only touched the ball 9 or 10 times in that football game. But you know who he reminded me of? Percy Harvin, when he played for the University of Florida. The guy's got that kind of skills.
Wow, wow. He has 152 yards tonight on 7 carries, 1 TD.
Dominguez in to kick off from McEachern. Mills and Allen back deep to receive for the Broncos, 17-3.
Brookwood has to be coming up with a master plan right now. They really have to put their heads together to make sure that they can steal this momentum back. They have to take the momentum back on their sidelines, edifying his players, making sure that a quarterback is in a good position. Get back to the basics. Put the ball in your running back's hand, Mr. Brown.
Mickey Creighton does a good job there on the short kick, because obviously after 10 yards it's a live ball. Kind of landed in between a couple of Broncos. Creighton did a good job to receive it on the bounds and prevent what could have been another special teams miscue for the Broncos. Instead, it's first down and 10 for the Broncos. Pretty good field position here at the 34-yard line. You see McClain checking back into the football game. He got the play directly from the coach there. And they hurry to the line of scrimmage. Two backs in the backfield and an offset eye. Man in motion is Collins. Pitch running behind Collins, and a beautiful tackle there made on the outside. Wonderful pursuit by Henry Famura for a no gain. He's the backside defensive end, Keelan, coming across the formation and making a tremendous tackle.
You're talking about pursuit to the football here, baby. This is what you want. They call this head hunting. Look at him. Ah, that's aggressive, baby. That is aggressive.
Famura's a returning starter. Easily the best player they've got on defense. He's already committed to Louisville. 70 total tackles and 70 sacks last year. And believe it or not, his coach said that he might still be learning the game of football.
Look at those pythons on him. You can tell he eats the weight room up.
Shotgun formation on second and nine for McClain. Steps into his throw, finds Brown at the 40. Brown breaks a tackle, but can't break another one as he's knocked flat on his rear end. Just before reaching the 45-yard line, he needed to get just past the 44 for a first down. Let's check the spot. It'll be awfully close.
Well, Trey, I can tell you, there's some hitting going on out on that field. As you can see, the specimen and the skill level of Brown in the free safety coming up, Mr. Thomas just laying a licking.
Now, Thompson, Darius Thompson, the senior, replaces a guy who's now playing at Georgia Southern by the name of Kel Parham, who I thought was the biggest hitter I saw last year. And Darius Thompson ain't too shabby himself. Nice hit on Josh Brown, but it was good enough for a Brookwood first down. First down and 10 from the 44.
Might I add, Darius Thomas is committed to Miami of Ohio.
And a no gain up the middle as they give it to the fullback, Collins. And he is stacked up immediately. He goes nowhere. A host of McEachern Indians making the tackle, including number 50, Nick DeMassimo.
His defense is showing a little aggressiveness. Somebody else right there going down. It seems like some cramps going on there. Andrew Traver.
Yeah, the sophomore is down. Like you said, possible cramps. That's a big young man, 6'4", 320 pounds.
Woo.
When those guys go down, they stay down.
That's his mama grocery bill is high.
Let's take a look at McEachern's resume. 2012 region champions, 15 region championships overall, third region title out of the last 4 years, four straight playoff appearances, won nine or more games from 1985 to 1989. And we talked about Jimmy Dorsey and his influential role here in the Kell Classic, but he was a pretty doggone good coach too. 1984 to 07, 219-66-1.
This team knows how to win. Four straight playoff appearances back to back. That's immaculate. If you can go there four times in a row, you got to be doing something right in your program.
Made the playoffs 18 straight times also from 1985 to 2002. Top-rate program here in the state of Georgia. Brookwood comes to the line of scrimmage. Second down and long from the 45-yard line. Give Brown. He's got some tacklers. Linebackers come up well and stop him just shy of the 50-yard line. It'll bring up third down and manageable for Brookwood as they threaten to get in to McEachern territory, trailing 17-3 with just over 10 minutes to go here before half.
Yeah, Brookwood definitely have to go. They've been doing north-south the past couple plays, and it's actually working for them. Looking to do something mixed directional to get the defense off the heels. McEachern's doing a great job of subbing the defensive tackles. As you can see, they're too deep there. They have rotated about every three plays, so they're trying to keep those big fellas up front fresh.
Collins in motion to the near side. Passing is McClain, and looks like Allen slipped down at the 44-yard line, so the pass will be incomplete, and looks like the Broncos will have to punt again. And that's a great point that you just made, Keelan. I've noticed that as well, that McEachern, knowing that Brookwood's going to test the defensive line, running off guard and off tackle most of the line, they're trying to keep those guys fresh. Lucky Daniels came into the game just before that last snap.
Right. That's important. You're a wing tee offense in Brookwood. You would think the coaching staff would pick up on that a little bit, take advantage of those guys running in and off the field. You try to not necessarily a hurry-up offense, but you want to get the play in a little bit quicker to get those defensive linemen off the heels.
Grant Hill to punt from his own 34-yard line. It is a nice spiral kick. And it bounces down, and it might have coffin corner out of bounds. We'll see. beautiful kick out of bounds at the 4-yard line.
That's a very
best special
nice
teams play by far for the night for Brookwood.
Very, very nice play.
47-yard punt by Grant Hill.
All right, let's see if this defense can get it cranking, get it going. They have a lot. Hey, there's a lot of football left, Trey. And then going into the halftime, you have to steal this momentum. You can, you got them pinned to their own end zone. You want a turnover right here. You want to strip the ball. You got to get this defense going.
Let's get an injury update down on the sideline from John Nelson. Nelly, what do you got?
Two injuries this time on the McEachern sideline, but it's so far it's good news. Christian Roberson, I talked to him. He said he just got rolled. He's taking water. He's just trying to walk it off. The larger issue almost was Michael Williams. They were looking at his left shoulder. They were doing range of motion testing, and he's passed it for now. So once he gets full 360 degrees, or if he can do the proper touches up in the air, he'll be heading back out. So you're two for two.
There you see Clemens' stats. 2 of 5 for 17 yards passing. 2 carries, 17 yards. Bad snap. He gets on it. He's got some running room, and a tackle's eventually made at the 22-yard line. Making something out of nothing is the senior quarterback, Ty Clemens, 18-yard carry on what was a broken play.
As you see the bad snap there, you can just tell how this defense is just locked in, and they're just playing just sound football. But, hey, mistake happened, and Ty just impromptu picked it up, and just and he gained a nice game there.
Looked like that might have been where the play was intended to go originally because he had blocking out front. Could have been a disaster. It turns into a first down for Clemens. They're in the pistol again. Come back on the delay. Coming inside's Ryan Sherman. Helmet goes down and a couple flags go down as well. And that's Matt Price, slow to get up for the Broncos, number 16. And the officials will talk it over. And they'll let us know what the infraction is. It'll be holding on McEachern, yet another penalty. These, you said something earlier, Keelan, these can be drive killers. McEachern should be very fortunate to be up 17-3 in this game. If it weren't for number 7, it may be a whole different story for McEachern, because these penalties in a normal game situation against a quality team, you'd lose.
Definitely lose, especially if Brook was a little bit more of it on time with their offense and get things moving.
During the play, we had holding on the offense, 10-yard penalty. First down.
77 there as he pulls. Right there, yeah, he grabbed his jersey and pulled him down.
And that's the extremely talented junior Chuma Edoga, who's already been offered by the University of Georgia. There's the penalty story.
85 yards.
Give from left McEachern. Side. Let's talk about Chuma Edoga, the big junior. This guy's got one more year in the program. Coach Hockman was very transparent with us. As a matter of fact, he told us last year when we covered this guy as a sophomore that by the time it's all said and done, we'll probably be the best offensive lineman he's ever had the privilege of coaching. Yeah. And they're running behind him the majority of the time tonight.
Yeah, and to point out, too, he lost his father last year around Christmas time. And you know, his mother and himself have been willing and openly to talk about it. And I guess that's how it's getting him playing football and giving him the encouragement to get out there and play with his teammates. As you can see, he has offers from Clemson and Georgia. 6'3", 275-pound junior. That's it.
That's a big boy.
That's a big guy.
And probably the highest praise for a high school football player, in my opinion, is when a coach talks about the physical attributes of his player and then he immediately follows it up with, but you know what? He's an even better kid, and that's right. What he says about Chuma.
Right. That's unbelievable. You can have a leader on your offensive line to take on that leadership role. You need someone who's smart. You need someone with good character, because that's what teams are looking for these days.
Third down and 16 for McEachern. Play action. Rahming outside, has blockers, gets to the outside with a nice block. Now tries to cut inside before being taken down. Spun down, in fact, to the 26-yard line by Matt Price.
This is a great play by Matt Price. Nice, quick stop route on the outside, and he got his offensive lineman and got his fullback out there. As you can see, his teammates and the tight end coming out there to block out front. That's a very high percentage pass. A great open field tackle by Matt Price.
A phenomenal block there by tight end Trey Scott on Nick Aubie. Two very good players in their own right, but it wasn't quite enough. as it'll be fourth down and a long five, and they ran their offensive unit out there, and the next thing that happened was, you fill in the blank here, Keelan.
A penalty.
It's a timeout for Brookwood. They want to think it over. We're going to take a timeout, too, with 7 minutes and 23 seconds to go in the second quarter. Brookwood trails sixth-ranked McEachern by a score of 17-3. Don't go anywhere. You're watching the Kell Classic on GPB.
Sports Medicine South, led by Dr. Gary Levengood, is an all-inclusive orthopedic surgery and sports medicine practice. We currently serve as the sports medicine provider for the GHSA and multiple teams across Gwinnett County. Sports Medicine South, Atlanta's sports medicine specialist.
Georgia Peanut Commission, offering power-packed Georgia peanuts as a delicious snack and fuel for the big game. Georgia peanuts are the official state crop of Georgia, with almost half of all peanuts in the U.S. produced by Georgia farmers.
Be sure to catch GPB's Emmy Award-winning nature series, Georgia Outdoors. This fall on GPB, see the beauty of the state in all four seasons of its glory and find out about its remarkable natural habitats. That's Georgia Outdoors next Sunday at 7:30 only on GPB.
Oh, I'm scared of snakes. Saw that snake going across the screen.
I'm not kidding.
It's made me give me the heebie-jeebies.
Poisonous, not poisonous, big, little. I'm staying away.
It doesn't matter. Well, you're like 6'4", 275.
I'm staying away.
Nice and lean. You scared of snakes?
I'm terrified of snakes.
Me too, man. Me too. We'll be sitting there hugging each other, man.
If there's ever a snake in the booth, or if you ever hear dead air, there is a snake in the booth. McEachern forced a punt on fourth down and five. Dominguez, low, line drive. And Matt Pryson to receive the kick at the 43-yard line. His first attempt receiving a kick, a 31-yard kick by Dennis Dominguez. And let's take a look at the Brookwood Hall of Fame. We alluded to it earlier. We call that a teaser in the business. And there you see the guy you talked about earlier, Rennie Curran.
Yeah.
Also, Sean McGee, who played defensive end for Brookwood last year, and a lot of other guys that went to some great schools. Kellen Williams to Bama. Kenny Miles, a great tailback playing currently. Or just graduated, excuse me, from South Carolina. Maybe the most famous of all was a kicker by the name of Jason Elam, who played for Hawaii, later the Denver Broncos, one of the best kickers of all time.
Elam went to Brookwood? You guys put some boys in the NFL there, Trey.
He was the first.
Wow.
And on the first down play from scrimmage, there's a penalty. Shocker. Let's find out what the call is. Brookwood still desperately trying to get that running game going.
Oh, it's another penalty, Trey?
Yeah.
Okay.
Tell you one thing right now, Keelan, if these guys on the officials crew, if they work out, they can skip cardio this week.
they sure can, man. They've been getting their money's worth tonight.
We have holding on the offense. We have a personal foul on the defense. Penalties offset by rule. Replay, first down.
Let's check out the personal foul on the outside. You can appreciate this a little bit, Keelan.
Yes, sir. I can appreciate that. I can appreciate that the cornerback
got a little fabric, got a little face mask, got a little flesh.
Yeah, sometimes you got to, you know, I can appreciate the wide receiver coming off the ball. He's doing what he's supposed to. You can't let the defense know that you're coming to block him. So you have to make sure everything looks the same. You have to run your routes the same. You have to go block the DB the same. You have to keep that defense honest. And the cornerback just didn't know how to handle himself.
235 total yards in penalties, Keelan.
Yeah.
23, excuse me, those are the rushing yards. I'm so used to penalties, I got penalties on the mind. Rushing yards being dominated big time by McEachern, thanks to Taj Griffin. Brookwood going to the air on first down and 10.
Had Matt Price wide open. It was just a little bit too mustard on the ball there for him. I like the thinking of Brookwood. Doing a little misdirectional passing, misdirectional running. Trying to give this team a chance here, Trey. Trying to give their team, the Brookwood, a chance here.
Forcing McLean's hand in the pocket was none other than the defensive end, Henry Fumura, the Louisville commit, and it'll bring up second down and 10 for Brookwood from the 42-yard line. And quickly up to the line of scrimmage for Brookwood. Toss sweep, near side. Brown, and he's taken down. No, second effort past the 45-yard line. not close to a first down, but a nice, tough, gutsy run for the senior tailback, and a good job bottling him up for several blue jerseys, including number 98, McKinsley Billingsley.
One thing I can respect is a hard-running running back. When I played safety, I didn't really like going against hard-nosed running backs. You know why? Because they never stop moving their feet, and they're hard to tackle. And that's what Brown is doing to this defense tonight.
And that's the way this Brookwood offense is designed to work. It's designed to wear you down. Plenty of time left on the clock to stick with your game plan. But Brookwood here passing on third down. He's got a man. Looks like Matt Price out at the 43-yard line. If it's a clean reception, it's good enough for a first down. And that was Mike Allen making the catch in traffic. He seems to be tonight, Keelan, the go-to guy in the passing game for Brookwood.
Yes, he's running his route. I just really like how he's keeping his arms moving, chopping it up. He's going up, catching the ball at the high punt. He's trying to make up for those drop balls he had earlier today. But nice route by Mike Allen. He's a very talented kid in his coach's eyes.
It's a young man that is a move-in for Brookwood, played at Central Gwinnett last year. He's got big shoes to fill. Their go-to wide receiver last year was Kai Priester, who went to Clemson, and he caught 9 touchdowns and over 1,000 yards receiving. That's big shoes to fill, but so far tonight, Mike Allen has done a fantastic job.
Timeout, Brookwood.
Brookwood takes another timeout. They want to talk it over. Let's toss it downstairs to John Nelson. Nelly?
Just because we're here at the Dome, we've been here since 9 o'clock in the morning, doesn't mean that there are other games that haven't been going on, and there's a way that I can also promote the fact that we have an app for that. You can get all the scores updated if you download our app. You can go to GPB Sports, download the app. It's free. You get to pay attention to everything that's going on in high school sports, all the up-to-date information, all the blogs, all of that stuff. You can do it at our app at GPB Sports. Now, there were two big games in Gwinnett County that happened earlier today, and it was not good news for Georgia squads. Number 1 versus number 6, Booker T. Washington out of Miami and Norcross. Booker T. Washington 55-0 over Norcross. And the other game, the first game of that doubleheader at Norcross, was South Gwinnett and Tallahassee Lincoln. Tallahassee Lincoln had a 31-14 lead at the break. They ended up winning 34-21 over South Gwinnett. A bunch of other scores. Yesterday, Brooks County beat Clinch County, the first game back for the folks in Quitman. Jefferson County beat Fitzgerald. First full weekend, obviously, is next weekend. But, guys, this is the kickoff of the high school football season. We wouldn't have it any other way.
Nelly, I'm sharing a booth with a very gloating Keelan Johnson, Florida boy.
Oh, yes.
High school quarterback from down in South Florida. And he's been giving me a hard time ever since that game kicked off.
Who, me?
Because Booker T was putting a whooping on Norcross.
Yeah, 55-0, man. That's some good football there, baby.
I will say that I do not believe that is indicative of Florida or Georgia as a whole. And I'll just leave it at that.
Oh, man, there's a lot of football left. We have so many games to cover, and so much high school football is going to be played in this great state of Georgia. I'm just happy to be here to be sharing the booth with you this year, Matty.
Second down and 5 for Brookwood inside McEachern territory. Play action on second down. Billingsley with the pressure, and Famura and Billingsley both collide and converge on McLean at the same time for the big sack, a loss of 4 on the play, and it'll bring up a big third down. Henry Famura, the Louisville commit, we're calling the young man's name a lot here in the second quarter. He is wreaking havoc anytime Brookwood tries to drop back and pass tonight.
Trey, his motor just doesn't stop. I can appreciate why he's going to Louisville, because Charlie Strong wants aggressive defensive ends that's not going to give up on a play. He hustles that quarterback down and gave him a sack from the back. Joy McLean's going to feel that one in the morning.
And Keelan, I got to share a booth with you all year. So yeah, you're going to have to chill out. I'm not going to get a chance to redeem myself. I don't know how many more times. I know Grayson is going to play a team from Florida
right
in a couple of weeks. Colquitt's going to play Hoover, but that doesn't have any bearing on our relationship.
No.
So
it's okay.
I need you to respect. You're going to share the booth with me. Now you got to respect Georgia High School football.
Can I give you a hug?
No, no, we're not going to hug it out on TV. After we get off air, we'll hug it out. I'm not comfortable with that yet.
Okay, no problem, man. Maybe next game.
And Nelly down on the sideline, you have any input on this? We got to gang up on this guy, 2-1,
well,
Georgia against Florida.
He's 1-0 because Daytona Beach Mainland actually won 14-9. They beat Lake Mary. So
see,
you're 1-0 on the year, and you've got DeLand
next week. Why did I toss
week.
It?
That's
Why
awesome,
did I
man.
Toss it down to you
Nelly,
for news like that?
Nelly, we're going to have a great relationship this year, Nelly. I appreciate you, man. I appreciate you.
I'm easing the new guy into the operation.
Oh,
that's
gotcha.
How it goes.
We're stroking the ego a little bit.
He's making me feel
kid,
a little
bit
better.
We're handling with you with the kid gloves.
For now.
Okay.
For now, he's getting kid
It's a good
gloves.
Thing
First
you're a UGA guy.
Box.
It's a good thing you're a UGA guy because that totally redeemed
yeah,
you.
Yeah, I appreciate that. What do you think, Nelly?
Yeah, well, like I said, I think that one of the running things we ought to do is have Daytona Beach Mainland scores every week as part of this.
Right.
And if there's a way we can do it on the GPB Sports app, we'll definitely find a way to do it.
Good call, Nelly.
But, you know, hey, yeah, first time out, Keelan. Tonight, you get the hall pass.
You get
Next
a screen
week,
pass.
It's all off.
Thank you, Nelly,
Third
for
down,
the love.
Screen pass to Brown. It's down close to the 40-yard line, but will still be significantly short. And that's got to be awfully risky. Got to make your heart race if you're McLean on a screen pass, knowing that those guys are going to come free, the guys that have been harassing you all night, and that's by design.
This is a delayed screen pass there. This defense has been doing a good job in working to get into the second level. The defensive line up front, the smart player, as McKenzie and Julian, those guys are creating lanes for these linebackers to come through and make plays in the second levels. That's what good defensive linemen do for their linebackers. That's what makes this defense a special defense.
And a bad snap. And he gets the kick off, does Grant Hill. Not a bad kick considering yeah. the circumstances. It rolls out of bounds right at the 20-yard line. It'll be first down and 10 for McEachern after a 20-yard punt. Brookwood so far hasn't been able to muster much on offense since that initial drive that ended in the 36-yard Brandon Morrow field goal. 3:41 to go here before half. McEachern up 17-3. It's been the Taj Griffin show up till now. Over 100 yards rushing so far. A big 90-yard touchdown run and a long run earlier that set up a Ryan Sherman touchdown for McEachern. So right now everything clicking except the penalty story for McEachern.
I want to see more of Taj Griffin. I haven't had enough, I'm gonna be honest with you, Trey. He is a great specimen to see. It's very refreshing to see a very talented running back, skilled, athletic receiver and running back. He has 7 carries for 152 yards tonight. And it's not even his second half.
Nice job there by Clemens, putting it in the belly of Alize Chubb, pulling it out. Spin move and running over a defender at the 35-yard line, which will be good enough for a first down. And here you see on display the running ability of the quarterback, Ty Clemens.
Ty Clemens, they have so many athletes on their team. I'm be honest with you. I kind of, not necessarily struggled, I enjoyed preparing myself in the number 2 and the number 3 depth chart for this team because they have so many weapons. It was so much positive things to say about this athletic offense.
You know, our producer, Steve Brand, thinks that they might be good enough to beat a couple of Florida schools.
You know what? The talent that I'm seeing here tonight, hey, it will be a great football game, and hopefully we can cover it right
that's,
here.
That's a very politically correct answer, and I appreciate that. First down run here by Alize Chubb. Nice, tough running up inside. He's their bruiser.
Yes.
And he does a great job right there getting to the 45-yard line and picking up a new set of downs for the Indians.
If he would have kept his feet, I'm telling you, he probably got 5 or 6 more yards on that carry.
Malik Lewis touching the ball for the first time tonight on a nice pass there. So far in this drive, Keelan, you've seen a nice run and now a nice pass by the senior quarterback, Ty Clemens.
Nice poise. Hands up high, ball up high for Ty. Nice pitch and catch to his receiver on a nice 5 to 6 yard out.
A little miscommunication there with the officials. They clear it up, and it's first down and 10 for McEachern. Chubb again. And he's taken down almost immediately. Tackle made there by the defensive end, number 78, senior Nigel Simmons. He'll play mostly in a rotation tonight with the junior, number 30, Chad Price. But Simmons does a great job
yeah,
there.
They talk about that matchup. These two guys are really starting. They're fighting for a starting position. The coaches said, hey, they're one and the same. These two kids are, when you ask them to do something, they do anything you ask them to. So you can win with either or.
Two tight end formation here on an offset pistol. And a pitch for the first time tonight to your guy, Taj Griffin, as he goes down just shy of the 40-yard line at the 39-yard line. I think, Keelan, that's probably the best job Brookwood's done containing him so far tonight.
That's a nice job by the defense, but also I love the play calling. How this is a very gutsy call, come down the line with the play action with the option. That is nice to keep your defense very honest. And like I said, one of the keys Brookwood really have to do is they just have to read their man. Don't try to do someone else's job. Do your job. That's the number one key to playing a defensive back or playing a defensive linebacker. Do your job when you're going against such an athletic offense. You just have to do your job. The defense is made to win. You stick with the program, I promise you, you'll be successful.
37, pistol here. Initially, Clemens was hemmed in, and then he finds the corner, and he's ridden out of bounds by corner Daquan Joy. He almost was tackled for a loss. The defender lost his helmet. Pressure made there by defensive end senior Casimir Isles, who moved down to defensive end from inside linebacker, and he darn near had a sack here.
Oh, he almost had him. This tie is a great specimen. Look at the blocking by the receiver out front, Williams, the senior. That's what coaches really like. That's what coaches like to see when they put on the game film. Who's blocking? Who's doing the little things when nobody's looking?
That's a great point, Keelan, and it was good enough for a first down. So you can't underestimate the contribution that Williams made there for his block. He keeps the sticks moving for McEachern, and they've got a nice sustaining drive going here with just a minute 30 left to go before halftime and a 17-3 lead. Clemens checking the sideline for the play. Two tight end formation, pistol for the Indians. Play action. Going up top, got a man, it's Romming, and it's underthrown just slightly. Otherwise, it would have been a touchdown. Covering on the play was Matt Price.
Oh, this is just a bad decision by Ty right there. He just tried to lop it up too much. He should have just followed through. As you can look on the receiver was ready. He had the defense beat by 10 to 15 yards. Hope the fellas all right over there.
When you get your running game working and those ends and those linebackers and those safeties start to key on the quarterback and the running back and all those weapons you keep talking about, it just primes the Brookwood defense to go deep. An accurate throw, you have 6 points there.
That's why the play action pass is probably the most popular pass in all of football.
They go back to Taj Griffin, and he trips over one of his own offensive linemen for, I believe, his shortest gain of the night, maybe 2-3 yards.
It's like, come on. You guys are hurting my running average, man.
Which is astronomical, I might add, right now.
Look at this right here. He's so athletic. He knows this could be a little bit more than the 2-yard gain.
6'4", 235-pound right guard Chandler Jones. Those guys can't just scoot out of the way quickly.
Yeah, they can't. Those meet up front, baby.
Pistol formation, third down and 10. Clemens surveying the field. Nowhere to go, stops, throws way over the head of his tight end, Trey Scott, falls incomplete. Young man's lucky not to have that one picked off. And we'll see, they're in no man's land, Keelan. The ball's gonna be spotted at the 33-yard line.
Yeah, look at this right here. He has somebody scrambling a little bit. He's wide open. He's begging for the ball, begging for it. And you know, that just speaks on Ty. Ty, he doesn't know it all. He has still have a lot to work. This is his team now. This is his first game. I'm sure coach is going to put him in that film room first thing on Sunday or Monday and say, hey, this is how we can get better as a team. We love what you're doing for us. We know what you can do for us, but we need you to manage this ball club and make the right decisions at the right time.
Fourth down for McEachern. Pressure. Clemens steps up into the pocket and now heaves it out toward the sideline. A fairly accurate pass, but I don't believe it was caught, and it was not. It was dropped incomplete. Nice heads-up play as they try to get the ball on the outside to number 3, Ryan Sherman, who already has a rushing touchdown here tonight. Good heads-up play for Clemens. Ryan Sherman just couldn't come down with it. It'll be a turnover on downs, and Brookwood will take over.
Ty does a great job with his feet. He's keeping his play alive. Very athletic move. This ball should have been caught. It really should have been caught, and that would have been a first down. Good job by Brookwood, but getting some pressure on the Ty. Hey, kudos to this defensive coordinator who's calling these blitzes, keeping him honest, trying to keep him in the pocket, because he knows Ty can hurt them with his feet outside the pocket.
And what I like about the senior quarterback is he doesn't run off the field and go find a home on the bench and put his head down. He's standing right beside his offensive coordinator. He's getting coached up so he can come back and do better on the next series. Now Brookwood takes over on downs with just 37 seconds to go and all three timeouts. It'll be interesting to see here what they decide to do before the half, trailing 17-3.
Got to take a shot.
Here they go. Oh. Looking down the seam to fullback Josh Collins. It falls incomplete. You got a couple of guys scrapping down there. It's Henry Fumura mixing it up with number 74 for Brookwood.
I think this
and that's
is a,
Griffin Perkins.
I think this is a great call. He's open. He's right there. He just lost sight of the football. Safety comes up and try to make a physical hit on him. The cornerback. Yeah. He's actually their number one man-to-man go-to guy outside on outside, but he's actually playing safety on that play.
And here you see the fullback, the intended receiver on the previous play, Josh Collins, checking out of the football game. Looks like he may have taken a shot to the ribs. And meanwhile, on the field, second down and 10 for Brookwood at the 33-yard line. 31 seconds to go in the game. Single back formation, man in motion. From right to left, up the middle, Collins has some running room. Tries to spin through a couple defenders. Is eventually tackled at the 40-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 7 yards on second down. And we'll see if Brookwood takes their timeout here. It doesn't look like they will as the clock continues to run. And now they finally call a timeout after letting 7-8 seconds run off the clock. And once again, Josh Brown for Brookwood is down on the field. Remember, Keelan, he came off the field just a few plays into this game and came back. Didn't look like he's missing a beat, but he might be struggling with cramps here.
Yeah, this is an interesting moment because this is the leader. This is the heart and soul of their team. And the trainers are looking over him right now. And as you can actually see, he was hitting the ground pretty aggressively. This must be pretty serious because he doesn't want to be in this position.
They're being very gentle with him because, you know, based on the fact that they're not stretching out the calf muscle, Keelan, it may not be cramps. It could be that he tweaked his knee. And Darius Thompson, you see up there, making a clean tackle on the young man, and he'll walk gingerly off the field.
It's good to see him get up and walk off this field.
9 carries for 23 yards for the young man. And it's been an up and down half for both of these teams. Right now, McEachern with the advantage on the scoreboard. They'll wind the clock down inside 10 seconds. McLean sets to pass, looking sideline, finds Mike Allen, and he makes a wonderful catch at the 47-yard line before being pushed out of bounds.
Nice throw by Joey McLean, and nice connection with Mike Allen. Look at this body control. As you can see, the quarterback sets his feet, and look at those feet. Look at those hands. Eyes and hands in the basket. Great catch by Mike Allen. You know, to talk about Josh Brown, the only good thing comes from his injury, Trey. I'm going to be honest with you. It's going to give somebody else an opportunity to step up tonight. This is the first game of the season. You have to find another leader in this offense, whether it's a running back or a receiver, to take over.
Now, I will say Brookwood still has all three timeouts. The stoppage on the clock on the play was the injury by Brown. And time will expire here. They call a couple timeouts. They might have given their preseason All-State kicker, Brandon Morrow, a chance to attempt a long field goal, but they opt to put all three of those timeouts in their pocket and go to halftime trailing 17-3. It's been a very up and down half, to say the least. McEachern has put on display all their skill position players. Brookwood can be encapsulated by saying they have not been able to run the ball, and that's where we stand, 17-3, and we go downstairs with the coach. John Nelson standing by. Nelly.
Thank you, Trey. Let's talk about one thing that probably you didn't like and one thing you did. First thing, obviously, penalties first half.
Yeah, you know, first game, I guess. Hopefully that's what the jitters are. And I think as officials, they get jittery, too. They like to throw a lot early on. But, you know, I just want to praise God. We got some great talent. You can see, obviously, he's blessed us to have great facilities at our place and people and some great talent.
I was going to say, let's talk about talent. 2-7, Taj and Ty again. First half came up big.
No question. There's some good players. If we can just do simple things, let them do their thing, I think we'll be okay. But, you know, Brookwood's a tough, gritty team. They're going to keep fighting. There's no question. We got to play better in the second half.
Thanks for your time, Kyle. Go for it.
You bet.
Over to Mark, best seat in the house.
Hey, thank you very much, John Nelson. Coming up at our halftime show, we'll hear from both marching bands and talk to our final two principals of the night.
That's right, and we'll find out what's going on at Brookwood and McEachern High School, plus scores from all of today's games. It's all coming up next on the Metro PCS Halftime Show on GPB.
Sprint Turf, manufacturer of synthetic turf systems for sports like football, field hockey, baseball, and soccer. Sprint Turf synthetic turf systems are made in the USA and have been installed in more than 900 locations across North America. Sprint Turf provides sports field solutions for high schools, colleges, and professional sports teams worldwide. From recreational leagues to elite level athletic programs.
Talk about the teams trying to get to the next level.
Think all that homework won't lead to anything? Enter GPB's video contest, win $1,000, and make a difference.
Did you mean to throw this away?
How can you help stop the drop?
The German Consulate in Atlanta, encouraging you to study German and to learn more about our diverse culture with much to discover in 2013. More information about Germany as an environmental leader and other current topics on the web at germany.info/Atlanta.
Welcome back to the Georgia Dome. McEachern leads Brookwood 17-3. This is the fifth and final game of the Metro PCS Corky Kell Classic. I'm Mark Harmon.
And I'm Kat Carney. There's a lot of excitement here in the Georgia Dome and a lot of interest in the Metro PCS Corky Kell Classic online. So let's check in with Grace Olson, our social media correspondent.
Getting all of your fan tweets today. You've been sending in pictures showing your spirit. I want to show you a few of those. The first one we have from Alyssa Cagle. She says, my little bro at the Pea Ridge game this morning. She's an alumni. Also, the next photo we have is from at Infinity CJG, having so much fun at the Dome. Go Brookwood. She's with our TV sign prop that we've been showing to fans all day long. The next one's from Reed Champion. How fantastic do we look right now? He says, you look fantastic, Reed. And then we go on to Sophie Perriott. She says, the Indians have arrived. The Indians and the Broncos have taken over the Dome. It may be late, but they are having a blast in the Dome. And if you weren't here to participate in all this action, make sure to like us on Facebook. There are tons of photos of cheerleaders, fans, the athletes, the band members. So if you know someone that was here at the Dome today, like us on Facebook, they may be on here. I'm going to send it back over to you, Mark.
All right, Grace, thank you very much. We welcome now to the program the principal of Brookwood High School, Debbie Deeds. And Debbie, what's going on at Brookwood these days?
Well, we've had a great start to our school year, Mark. We're glad to be down at the Dome tonight, as we are every year with the Corky Kell. It's a great way not only to kick off our football season, but to kick off the school year for the community. It's been wonderful here tonight to see all the little boys and girls of the Brookwood Football League.
And Debbie, you have brought down a ton of fans from Snellville.
Yes, we have. Our kids did a great job for us this week. We sold out of tickets. We got a great student section. We're very proud of them.
All right, it's time to play that game. Are you smarter than your students? Pick a question out of the helmet, and here we go. Who was the most recent inductee into the Atlanta Braves Hall of Fame? Was it A, Chipper Jones? B, Rudy Huxtable? C, the Hamburglar? Or D, Crayons?
I'm going to go with A, Chipper Jones.
You are right. You're smarter than your students. Thanks for coming on. Thanks for being a good sport. And good luck the rest of the season.
Thanks, Mark.
All right. Now let's check in with Kat Carney and the bands.
You know what? Now it's time to listen up. Marching bands are a huge part of high school football, and the Brookwood High School Marching Band is ready to prove it. Their performance is presented by Sonic.
Georgia heading your way. We've got a great schedule presented by the Georgia EMC. We kick things off next week at Grayson as the North Gwinnett Bulldogs travel to Grayson to take on the Rams. Week two, another big game between champions Buford and Gainesville, both champions, and we'll have that one for you in week two. Also, we'll visit North Cross, Marietta, Walton, North Cobb, and Milton. We'll see MLK take on Tucker. We'll wrap up the regular season with Flowery Branch at Gainesville. Then it's on to the playoffs and all the way to the state championship games right back here at the Georgia Dome. It all starts this Friday at 7 o'clock with our all-access pass pregame show. It is going to be a dynamite season of high school football.
It sure is. And, you know, we still have more coming in this program. We're going to check out all of today's scores, and it's all coming your way as the Metro PCS Corky Kell Halftime Show continues right after this timeout on GPB.
The wheels of progress haven't been very active lately. But because of business people like you, things are beginning to get rolling. And Regions is here to help, making it easier with the expertise and service to keep those wheels turning. From business loans to cash management, we want to be your partner moving forward. Let's get going together.
As the demand for power grows,
Georgia's nonprofit, member-owned electric cooperatives
are committed to providing safe,
affordable,
and reliable electricity
to our members.
We've been dedicated
to building strong
communities
for more than 70 years
and are proud to join
the Georgia High School Association
and Georgia Public Broadcasting
in support of our state's student athletes.
We are Georgia EMC, lighting the way.
Sports Medicine South, led by Dr. Gary Levengood, is an all-inclusive orthopedic surgery and sports medicine practice. We currently serve as the sports medicine provider for the GHSA and multiple teams across Gwinnett County. Sports Medicine South, Atlanta's sports medicine specialists.
Georgia Peanut Commission, offering Power Pack Georgia Peanuts as a delicious snack and fuel for the big game. Georgia Peanuts are the official state crop of Georgia, with almost half of all peanuts in the U.S. produced by Georgia farmers.
Welcome back to the Georgia Dome. Welcome back live on GPB. Welcome back to the Metro PCS Corky Kell Halftime Show live on GPB. We're at halftime of the Brookwood-McEachern game, and we welcome into the program the principal of McEachern High School, Regina Montgomery. Regina, tell us what's going on at the McEachern these days.
Oh, there's always something going on at McEachern. We just got through doing some athletic improvements to our stadium. I know you've heard about our new scoreboard, as well as
we biggest in the country, I hear.
That's what I've been told. And of course, you know, we have new turf, just a lot of things going on academically. We're getting ready to start restoring our greenhouse to help our kids get a different pathway as far as career tech goes. We're going to do some plant mutations and just giving them as many experiences as we can.
All right, you brought a big group of fans in here. Let's play the game. Are you smarter than your students? Pick a question out of our GPB football helmet. Let's see what lucky question you get, because it's the last one of the day. How many members on each football team can field during a play? A, it depends on their IQs. B, 11. C, any number that can be evenly stacked into human pyramids. Or D, 7, plus Vern Troyer if he agrees.
I think that's B, 11.
You not only are smarter than your students, you know your football. Thanks for coming on with us. Thanks for being
Thank
a good
sport.
Thank
you very much.
And good luck the rest of the season.
Thank you.
All right. Let's check in now with Kat real quick. And talk
about. Oh, you know what? Before we do that, I got to know, because we're about to wrap this up. How many Twitter followers do you have now?
Right now, it is up to 34 Twitter followers, if you can believe that.
I can believe it. I can believe it. You know what? I hear the band starting right now. So let's check in with the McEachern High School Marching Band. Their performance is presented by Sonic.
Great job by the McEachern Marching Band. Now, one of our key missions here at GPB is to focus awareness on the high dropout rate in Georgia high schools. We want to become a game changer on this important issue, so we created Stop the Drop.
Last year, 81 students entered GPB's Stop the Drop video contest. That's 81 videos that showed us why it's important to stay in school, and 81 students who helped raise awareness about Georgia's dropout rate. This year, GPB is looking to get even more students involved. The rules are simple. Make a 30-second PSA about the importance of staying in school, then register on our website. We'll pick the best entries, and students will vote for their favorites. This year's winner will take home $1,000. So, start filming.
Maggie, think about what you're doing. Dropping out will ruin your life.
Enter today. Help GPB stop the drop.
All right, get in on the action. For full details, just go to our website at gpb.org/stopthedrop. And boy, there's a big first prize, $1,000.
That there is. And let's recap all the scores from today's games. This morning, Kell beat Chattahoochee 26-8. Walton and Petrie Ridge took it 23-17. Colquitt County took it over Grayson 21-6. Camden County lost to North Gwinnett 34-14. And right now we're in the halftime. McEachern is winning over Brookwood 17-3.
Time now for our career play of the game, presented by the Technical College System of Georgia. Despite the changing job market in the state, many Georgians continue to find solid careers in the field of industrial technology. Careers include machine operators and designers, as well as industrial system managers and machine tool technicians. Areas of the field that are growing include cutting-edge trades like robotics and industrial design. It takes training and technical skills, but these jobs are available. You can build your own career. That's why industrial technology is our career play of the game. And this message is brought to you by the Technical College System of Georgia. Visit tcsg.edu for exciting career information. And we're getting ready to kick off the second half of this Brookwood McEachern game. But before we get back to the action, Kat's going to tell you a way to help keep programming like this. Great high school football on the great GPB.
That's right. Text a $10 donation to GPB to help keep programming like this on the air. All you have to do is text the letters GPB to the numbers 85944 and be sure to reply yes. Message and data rates may apply. Now let's send it back up to the booth to Trey McDaniel and Keelan Johnson.
Thank you very much, Kat. Just a few minutes away from kickoff here in the last half of football in what's been a phenomenal game of high school football. Game five culminates in just a few moments on GPB.
Can the Rise Up epidemic affect cognitive function? Observe. Tell me what you see.
That's Deku's pick against Peyton. See, we mixed up the coverage there.
And now?
Julio. Oh, the guy's a beast. Oh, somebody just got spooned. Oh, Tony G's abs. Can I keep that one?
Team is not something you do alone. Team is plural. Team is arms, legs, blood, sweat, and soul. A lot goes into team. But what we take away stays with us. Forever.
Welcome back to the Georgia Dome as we await the third quarter of the fifth and final matchup in the Kell Classic. The Brookwood Broncos and the McEachern Indians. Brookwood leads this one, trails this one 17-3 to the sixth-ranked McEachern Indians. McEachern has shown their talent on the field in a big way. They've been stubbing their toe a little bit thanks to penalties. But look at the highlights, Keelan. Take us through.
Yeah, it's been up and down tonight because of the penalties, but it's been some really good football going on. Brookwood came out and put three on the board first, and quickly, McEachern answered with a nice TD run. But my main man, number seven, Tyus Griffin, and he's been able to take the stable and put this team on his back with a nice running game. McEachern's done a great job of playing well on special teams, as you can see right there, coming back, answering with the field goal, and continuing to put the plays in their athletes' hands. And I really like how they continue to keep the momentum going, the nice balance on for pass and run.
Standing by on the sideline with Coach Cruz is John Nelson. Nelly.
Thank you, Trey. Here with the coach. Let's talk about two things. Obviously, the big thing, the injury to Josh. He was dinged up first half. How is he?
Well, you know, the doctor's still kind of looking at him, and we hope we can get him back. But we got a couple of other guys, I'm sure, that'll jump in there and try to take up the slack. But, you know, we hope it's not too serious, but I don't know yet.
All right, 15 penalties, both teams first half. Obviously, you know, first game jitters, and that was part of it.
Yeah, you know, we've like I told you earlier in the week, we got to play well on offense to keep their firepower standing over there watching a little bit. And we've made too many mistakes on offense with delay penalties and calling plays upside down and that kind of thing. So hopefully we'll get settled down and play better in the second half.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you.
We'll send it back upstairs. Trey and Kate, take it away.
Thank you, John. And there's a very telling story right there in our graphic, the Atlanta Journal and Constitution halftime stats. Anything stick out to you there, Keelan?
Look at the rushing yards by McEachern versus Brookwood. Brookwood normally known for their running attack, but today McEachern is taking the fish with this one, baby. 239 yards on rushing out of 17 attempts, and credit goes to Todd Griffin today, Trey.
Yeah, the young man was up over 100 yards before we even started the second quarter, and here we are about to start the third quarter, and I think Coach Cruz said it very well. If you're Brookwood, the team that's down in this game, the team that has to come back against a team with a lot of firepower, the best way to keep that firepower at bay is to keep their offense standing on the sideline. But in order to do that, you got to move the sticks, and it may be tough for Brookwood to do so. Right now, the doctor, as John Nelson just said, still evaluating their star tailback, Josh Brown.
And like I talked about before we went to halftime, somebody has to step up. And like I said, the only good thing about James getting hurt today is someone behind him getting opportunity and getting some leadership opportunities to let this coach know, hey, coach, call my number. I'm ready. I am ready. Put the ball in my hands. Put this team on my back. And they're going to need some help in order to come back from this so far.
And Brookwood will have to get it done on defense to start the second half as Brandon Morrow kicks the ball off to McEachern. It'll be caught by Sherman at the 10-yard line. He's got a seam on the outside, and he's taken down from behind, just shy of the 30-yard line at the 28-yard line, and that's where McEachern will start the second half as they're up 17-3 over Brookwood. And here comes their senior quarterback, Ty Clemens, who's been a little shaky in the passing game, but not bad stats for the first quarter of his senior year. 4 of 11, 39 yards through the air, 5 carries, 54 yards. But it sure helps when you can turn around and hand the ball to number 7, doesn't it, Kim?
Oh, yeah, I was just going to say, only because he has a great athlete behind him and beside him in Todd Griffin. We can continue to keep saying great things about Todd Griffin, but he's still a lot of a second half to play, and there's a lot of football to be played, and Brookwood needs to put their staple down to make their statement.
And there is play action to Taj, looking to go deep, now getting flushed out of the pocket. And there's a face mask penalty in the backfield. Clemens running, reversing field, picking up a first down, got a nice block, and goes out of bounds shy of the 50-yard line, and they may be tacking on 15 yards to the end of this run.
One thing Brookwood defense is having a hard time doing tonight is tackling. One thing about high school sports, you got it, there's no one missed tackle. Two missed tackles, three missed tackles. You have to be able to tackle and contain an elusive quarterback because he can hurt you with his feet.
That was defensive end number 22, Casimir Isles, in the backfield. It looked like he got a piece of Ty Clemens' face mask. And so it was a first down run, and the run was longer than the penalty would have been. So they're going to go ahead and decline the penalty as Coach Hockman, as he signals to the official, and it'll be first down McEachern. Nice improvisation work by Ty Clemens. He had a guy downfield initially, but he wasn't able to get the ball,
personal,
so he just does it with legs.
Face mask on the defense. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
Initially, Hockman thought that it was going to be an either-or situation. He signaled that he was going to decline it, and the officials explained to him that he was allowed to tack that onto the end of the run, and so he did. So that'll move the ball into Brookwood territory here. So
all the way down.
In a matter of 24 seconds, McEachern takes the ball from inside their 30 and now has the ball first down and 10 in Brookwood territory at the 38. Pistol formation, turns around, hands it to Taj, and Taj submarines his way to the 40-yard line, which will be a loss of a yard, and that is really the first time that Taj Griffin has touched the ball and taken a loss.
I just want to take a point out in this game. Look at the body language on the sideline. Hands are folded. Nobody's patting anybody on the butt. There's no encouragement coming from the coaches and the players. This Brookwood team seems like someone just kicked their dog. Come on now. You got to have high energy. This is an opportunity. First game of the year. You have to be excited about this opportunity to play in the Corky Kell Classic against McEachern High School.
Clemens takes a look at his OC to get the play. Pistol formation. He'll stand. He'll throw to the outside. It's T.J. Roming once again, who's been the go-to guy in the passing game, and it's a nice pitch and catch. And a gain of 5 or 6 yards on the second down play, which will bring up third down and manageable. And, you know, Keelan, I would have to imagine those high-percentage passes,
yes, sir,
for Clemens is really what's going to get him going.
It's going to get him going. Very, very, very nice high-percentage pass. Like you said, Taj Roming has did a great job of going up, getting the ball. This is a nice 5-yard stop and getting a little yak after the catch.
Coaches love that yak, Keelan.
Yeah, yards at the catch.
Third down and a long 4. Griffin, Clemens calls his own number, runs over a would-be tackler and gets down to the 21-yard line before being brought down by safety Matt Price.
As you can see, the read countering back to the opposite direction of the line. You have to give credit to this offensive line on the left side, left guard and left tackle. Two big SEC guys. They're definitely going to play on Saturday somewhere. And these guys, both of them are juniors, which is a good thing for McEachern's offense.
A very good thing for Coach Hockman here. He gives it to Alize Chubb. He can't quite get past the 20-yard line. Forward progress will get him up to about the 20, which is a 2-yard gain on first down. Not a bad job by the Brookwood front four. As you see now, Kyle Hockman, who calls the plays on the sideline for McEachern, is really trying to spread the wealth here just in this drive. You've seen Clemens touch it. You've seen Griffin touch it. You've seen Chubb, and you've seen T.J. Romming touch the football.
You can see they're looking over to the sideline, getting a check from the offensive coordinator. Tight going up to the line of scrimmage, yelling the coverage.
One step drop, Malik Williams on the outside, and he tries to get some of that yak, Keelan, before being driven out of bounds at the 10-yard line. If they mark it at the 10-yard line, it will be good enough for a McEachern first down. And they'll mark it at the 11, so it won't be first down and goal. It'll simply be first down. They can get to the 1-yard line for a first before it's first and goal, and they're picking up yards in chunks, Keelan.
Yak, yards after catch. Offensive coaches love it. Defensive coaches can't stand it. It all depends on what side of the ball you're on there. But great pick and pitch and catch by the quarterback to the receiver.
Pistol formation with Chubb standing just to the left of Clemens as McEachern's in the region's red zone, and he fires down low and incomplete.
Wow.
As he's looking for Trey Scott, very talented senior tight end, 6'4", 205. They've looked for him a couple times, but he has yet to get an accurate pass from his quarterback.
It's very athletic play. As you see, sideline, it hit him in his hands.
That was a great throw.
Very catchable ball. You got to be able to make those plays, baby. You're in the red zone. It counts right now. That's one thing that these coaches harp on. When you're in the red zone, we need points. We need points.
Straight shotgun this time with Taj Griffin to the right of Clemens. And they fake the pitch to him. He's got a seam inside. 5-4. Touchdown, McEachern. Ty Clemens calls his own number, and it's 11-yard scamper for a touchdown on their opening possession of the second half. They go up by a score of 23-3.
What just happened? I think he just faked me out. My eyes is at Brookwood's sidelines right there. What a great play by the quarterback by calling his own number. He was supposed to pitch the ball, but he gave a big head fake, as you can tell right there, and getting up there, going passing his offensive lineman. And nice stiff arm on the safety, Matt Price. Chugger, those guys open up those holes. This is the reason why McEachern's offense is successful. Yes, they have a lot of players around them, but they have a lot of meat up front. This group is very smart. This group asks a lot of questions, and they definitely want to understand the game of football. That's why they're in this position to win.
PAT is good. McEachern leads 24-3.
You have to seize any advantage you can get to build a career even while you're still in high school. That's why the Technical College System of Georgia offers dual enrollment. You earn college and high school credit at the same time, saving you money on college tuition. It's about your future. Dual enrollment jumpstarts your college education and prepares you for work in exciting career fields. Talk to your parents, school counselor, or a TCSG college about dual enrollment, or go to tcsg.edu.
Back to the Georgia Dome as McEachern leads Brookwood 24-3 after the 11-yard touchdown run by Ty Clemens. And let's take a look at our Georgia EMC Football Fridays in Georgia schedule. It is a good one. Keelan will be out at Grayson next week to catch a couple of teams that both played in the Kell Classic today. And then the following week is the game that everybody has circled on the calendar in the GPB office, and that's Buford at Gainesville as we get to see Deshaun Watson for the first time. A great group of games. Get to see McEachern once again at North Cobb. A DeKalb County matchup, MLK and Tucker.
Yeah.
And then we end the season with a great matchup, a game that might last 5 hours with those two offensive juggernauts, Flowery Branch and Gainesville. Looking forward to that one as well.
5 hours. You know, one thing I want to highlight, that MLK-Tucker game, I come from a line of good bands. And I heard that Georgia, that MLK and Tucker have some really good bands there, Trey.
Yeah, they really, anytime you go out to Hallford Stadium in DeKalb, that really take center stage. Last year, our own John Nelson got a chance to direct the Southwest DeKalb band. It was pretty epic.
John's getting down in the fun down there, huh, John?
You see our TCSG scoring drive, 8 plays, 72 yards, 3 minutes and 1 second.
My father was a drum major for Bethune-Cookman College, so I had no choice but to get involved in the band. I played alto saxophone, Trey, believe it or
you
not.
You told me that in our last break.
So I got
to bring that into the booth one night.
I love the bands, man. I love them.
Nick Albee, the backup tailback with Josh Brown out, gets the carry on first down and 10. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, and let's go downstairs to John Nelson and give us a little bit of taste of what we got last year, Nelly.
Yeah, although there's no ladder, and there's no band, and there's no music. So it was kind of like this. It was like Guy Lombardo, and I just completely and totally dated myself by saying something like that. It's New Year's Eve, Lawrence Welk, one and a two. This is kind of what we were doing at Southwest DeKalb last year. And there's a vicious rumor that, A, there's tape floating around to that. And there's also a vicious rumor that I danced at the basketball championships.
Oh,
I can deny that as well. I have no earthly idea what they were talking about there as well.
Oh, man, that's good stuff there, John. I can't wait to see you do it again this year, man.
I have no earthly idea what you're talking about, Keith.
I might join you this time.
A little something like this, maybe? Like that?
What is that, the heel toe?
What are you doing?
That's not what we're talking about.
No?
See, if you're not going to be honest with us, Nelly, we're going to have to go back and get the tape.
I have no traction.
Not the moonwalk.
See, what happened was my dress shoes.
Watch out for the pot line now. Watch out for the pot line.
I'm
okay,
there.
All right. I see you. A little balance. All right.
That's about enough of that.
You ain't lying.
Oh, man.
It's like I said, I have no earthly idea what you're talking about with this whole dancing and directing thing. No, that doesn't happen.
Third down and nine for the Broncos after the incompletion. Bad snap. McLean handles it, throws outside, and coming back to the ball is Mike Allen. He makes the catch near a first down, but there's another flag down. We'll check that. It was a nice job recovering for Joey McLean, and even better job by Allen to come back to the football.
That's one thing. That's football 101. A quarterback's kind of scramble. The guy that goes deep, he's always supposed to go back down. The guy that's short goes deep, and he fought, and he came back through running his route. Otherwise, that would have been an interception, possibly a pick six to the house.
The penalty is on Brookwood. Negates a great catch and a great move by Mike Allen on the outside. He's who they've tried to get the ball to in the passing game, with the exception of their first long pass of the game to tight end Sweeney. And by the looks of it, with 8:03 to go in the third quarter, if they don't tighten this game up, they're going to be going to the air a lot more than they want to.
Yes, sir.
Ineligible receiver downfield, 5 yards from the previous spot. Replay third down.
Trey, this team just looks like they don't have any energy whatsoever, you know? I understand they're in a bad situation. When I say it's a lot of football left, you got another quarter to go. Hey, one or two big plays here, they're back in the game.
Third and 14 for Brookwood, and from behind is Henry Fumura. He tries to pull a Lawrence Taylor on McLean and is unable to dislodge the ball, but it's still a sack for the Louisville commit, and it'll force a fourth down, and it'll force a punt for Brookwood. Watch the pressure here by number 15.
That motors continue to keep going. He makes the sack by getting blocked. Coaches want to see you make plays while you're getting blocked. You know, as a defensive tackle, that's what gets your defensive coordinator and your coaches excited, when you can make plays while getting blocked and getting off the field on third down.
Morrow standing at his own 8.5-yard line, ready to punt it away to McEachern's TJ Romming. There's a low, wobbly end-over-end kick, takes a Brookwood bounce, and Romming threatens to pick the ball up and then wisely backs off. It'll be touched dead at the 27-yard line. 47-yard punt for Brandon Morrow. Take a look here at the night that Taj Griffin has had. First, the long run, Keelan, that set up the Ryan Sherman touchdown.
Yes, sir. Very electrifying player. The coach said he loves him. Like I said, he loves life. And his aggressive play and play calling and running speaks a specimen about his personality off the field. Coaches say he loves his teammates. He loves going to class. He loves being around football. He's probably one of the best players he ever coached when it comes to just a team guy. This guy has a major upside. You see his weight, 171, 5'9", with 9 carries tonight for 152 yards and a touchdown. This guy, upside is nothing but through the roof of the dome tonight.
And he is not on the field right now, as they'll come out on first down with a 24-3 lead, 6:59 to go in the third quarter. And the deep man will be Chubb. We'll give the ball to him, and he's sniffed out immediately and brought down just shy of the 40-yard line by number 93 for Brookwood. And that is Janostin Bridges, who checks into the game for the first time tonight and makes a tackle.
There you go. Yeah, this is something they need. This is a start. You know, a TFL, first play from possession,
this is what Brookwood defense need. They definitely need to get it going and start making some plays in the backfield.
Off tackle to the left side. Nothing much doing again there for Alize Chubb. Tackle made by Will linebacker Chase Middleton.
This is a Division I football player. He runs well, good speed, and he actually can tackle in space. As you can tell, he's coming through the clear lane through the D lineman, making the tackle in the backfield, but the running back falls forward, and Chubb gets some extra yards.
Big third down here for the Brookwood defense as they try to get their offense back on field. To the air goes McEachern, and a first down conversion is made by Malik Williams on a beautiful pass, maybe the best pass of the night for Ty Clemens out on the sideline.
I think Ty Clemens can definitely get in the rhythm right now and focus on his passing game. He's calm. He don't have anything to prove right now. You know, he can just play pitch and catch with the receivers. This is the first game. You need to spread the wealth throughout this offense. Get some touches so you know exactly what you need to work on when you go in and watch film on Sunday or Monday.
First and 10 from the 46 in Brookwood territory. They go deep down the far sideline. There's coverage. And the pass is broken up. It was intended for TJ Romming. Number 48 for Brookwood in coverage. That's Jesse Brown. That's Josh Brown's younger brother, the sophomore, who you never know, by the end of the night, we may see him lined up in the backfield. He's kind of the heir apparent on offense, but you see him make a great play here on defense.
I really don't think Mr. Brown was really expecting to catch this ball because he saw it coming the whole time, but I don't think he really wanted to catch that ball. But good coverage by Jesse Brown.
Second down and 10 after the pass breakup. Up the middle is Sherman. Haven't called his number much since the first quarter touchdown, and he picks up a nice chunk of yardage on first down before getting taken down in the second level. It'll be a gain of 5, third down and a long 5 for McEachern coming up. Keelan, I'll ask you, with 5:10 to go in the third quarter, I know it feels like the fourth quarter because it's 11:30 at night, but when do you start beginning to try to eat clock and keep the ball on the ground? You got all those playmakers. It's awfully tempting to get them the ball in space. When do you make that shift?
Well, your main guy, Tyus Griffin's on the bench. You can see coaches doing a very aggressive rotation right now. Every other play, he's bringing in new running backs, new receivers, trying to get some new young guys some touches on the field. Now is the time. You definitely, hey, it's a little late. Hey, if people want to get up and go to church in the morning, hey, it's time to get this thing moving. Because unless Brookwood could just make a couple big stops and get some energy, because it's dead
prior
on the sideline.
Prior to snap, ball start on the offense, 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
Take a look here at the McEachern schedule. After the Kell today, they play in the Battle of the Big Chicken like they did last year, but they'll flip-flop games and they'll face off against Lassiter, a very good team in their own right, ranked number 9 at this point. And then they head into region schedule, and they are the odds-on favorite, Keelan, to win that region. They've won 4 out of the last 5 region championships. They're expected to do so this year, but in Georgia, anything could happen. And right now, they're concerned with the next 16 minutes of this football game and getting out of the Kell Classic 1-0.
Nice play by Nick Abe. This is a great one-on-one matchup on the outside. Isaac Bassett, that's a nice DB. We used to bat it ball down. As you can tell, he has inside position. As soon as he throws the ball, he's right there on the receiver. Nice play by Nick.
Nick Albee, somebody who played defense on this team last year, although not in a starting role. He's also the primary tailback now with Josh Brown out. And Brookwood's defense has answered when they needed to, forcing a McEachern punt. It's a good high kick for McEachern, and it takes a McEachern bounce inside the 5-yard line, and they do a phenomenal job of touching it dead between the 1 and 2 yard line. Great special teams play there for McEachern by number 30, Demery Hill. To all the Downton Abbey fans out there, we understand that it may be difficult to wait until the new year for the newest season to begin, so GPB has a special treat for you. Beginning September 12th at 9 o'clock, you can relive all the drama or catch up on episodes as GPB re-airs seasons 1 through 3 leading up to the season 4 premiere in January. So after the 45-yard punt from McEachern, Brookwood will start first down and 10 at the 2.5-yard line. Heavy formation for Brookwood now. Motion man comes back to the near side, and they'll run behind him. That's Nick Aubie, who just made the good defensive play, and he stopped for about a one-yard gain. And the natives are starting to get restless down there as tight end number 81, Keenan Sweeney, gets up in the face of one of his offensive linemen. He wants more production out of those guys.
Yeah, you got this is the time. Why not? Well, you know, he wants production. He's just not here for his health. Somebody somebody has to take charge. And ever since Josh Brown went down tonight, it seems like the life of the Brookwood offense and their defense just left the building.
Keelan, that's what you've been calling for the last 10 minutes is a little bit more life. So you can't fault the tight end for trying to get the troops rallied.
Sure,
sometimes
can.
It takes getting in somebody's face to do that.
Yes, sir. It sure does.
I formation this time on second down and long. Play action, pressure, it's Billingsley bearing down on McLean. He does a good job. He immediately sees number 98 from the left end coming at him. He does the right thing. He tucks the ball in, protects it, and falls over that goal line to prevent the safety. Yes. Take a look at Henry Fremour there, number 15. He's had a fantastic night as well.
They definitely, those two defensive ends, they run to the ball. They're hustle playmakers, and that's what you got to have. They got motors of steel there, man. Those guys cannot be blocked tonight, and that's one of the reasons why this McEachern defense, and the score is 33-24.
Two tackles, three assists, two tackles for loss. He's got a sack also that doesn't appear on that graphic. He's been everywhere, and so is his counterpart, number 98, Mackenzie Billingsley. And they try to go with the delay inside, just playing it safe as Nick Aubie gets it behind the guard on the left side of the line. It'll bring up fourth down and 11 and an obvious punting situation here for Brookwood. So their defense steps up. Keelan does a nice job to force a McEachern punt, and then they're not able to do anything with it, thanks to the tremendous upfield push by the front four from McEachern that we just highlighted.
Yeah, this front four has been really, really aggressive tonight, putting their offense in really good field position. Early in the game, their offense didn't do a good job of taking advantage of that field position because of penalties, but the second half has been a much better result of their defensive play.
Hill punting the ball away, not a great punt. Goes out of bounds around the 25-yard line. Let's take a look now at the McEachern Hall of Fame. They've had some really good guys come through there, including Adam Meadows. You look down there at A.J. Suggs, probably the best quarterback to come through here. Led them to a state championship game in 98 where they lost to Valdosta. Darius English, who played here just a few years ago in the Kell Classic. Nick St. Germain, a phenomenal kicker. The Edetabo boys, Amba and Etta. And Rajon Bennett, one of my favorite all-time high school football players. Obviously, we lost him tragically to an accident a couple of years ago before he was really able to show us what he could do at Vanderbilt. One of the nicest young men I've ever met. If his family is listening and watching tonight, we love you guys. And Rajon was an absolute joy to be around.
Yeah, he was. Hearts and prayers go out to his family.
So McEachern takes over a phenomenal field position after the short punt. First down and 10 at the 25, and if you're Coach Cruz and Brookwood, you're asking an awful lot of your defense right here because of the field position, already trailing 24-3 with 2:16 to go before the fourth quarter.
Now this defense definitely have to come together. Not a good punt whatsoever. He's trying to give up some of that field position. It's very interesting to see what McEachern is going to do. Coming out.
They'll come out in a pistol formation, a 4-3 look by the Brookwood defense. And they are obviously keen on Taj Griffin when he's in the game. He's been in the game, as you pointed out, Keelan, very sporadically here in the third quarter. So when he is in, they're keying on him, and he falls for a loss right there. I believe that's his second straight carry where he's been dropped for a loss. That did not happen in the first half.
It did not happen in the first half. I guess this is the momentum changes. I think McEachern's a little bit being more conservative in their play calling, running up the gut, not too antsy in the play calling when it comes to running the sweeps on the outside, running the gear on the outside. They're a little bit more conservative right now.
Pistol again. You see Trey Scott backing up at tight end. He'll go in motion now to the near side. Sprint out wide. They get the ball in space to Sherman. Malik Lewis unable to get the block on the outside and coming up and making a great tackle there for Brookwood is number 48. And that's Jesse Brown again.
Good contain.
Who has now been in the game for the last two possessions on defense.
Yes, sir. If you pay attention to this replay right here, you can tell Brookwood doing a great job of scraping and the linebacker staying free to make plays, and Jesse Brown coming up to making that tackle.
Brown has now made two good plays in the last few minutes. Sets up a third down and long for McEachern. This could be another big play for Brookwood if they're able to stop McEachern. Clemens has to go down, drops down, sidearm to try to get the ball out to Elijah Dorn. Dorn's only touched the ball so far once tonight. They're trying to get him the ball out in space, and that's a great call, Keelan. That ball, the trajectory was a lateral. If Brookwood's able to get on that, that's a big play. Take us through this a little bit.
Gutsy call right here by just trying to get the ball on a screen hitch there. Anytime the ball is thrown forward or behind the line of scrimmage, it's hot. So you have to play like a fumble. And in that time, great pressure on the quarterback there to get tied, to alter his passing motion. And it was kind of uncomfortable pass. And that's why it was a bad pass.
And if you're Brookwood, you have to be satisfied if you're the Brookwood coaching staff, because your defense just stopped McEachern three and out after they had the ball first and 10 at the 25-yard line to start the drive. Here's Dominguez. Kicks it rugby style. Price fakes like he's going to take the ball. Gets out of the way, and it's stopped dead at the 8-yard line. 30-yard punt for Dominguez, and Brookwood's offense has the ball. A little bit better field position this time, Keelan.
Yeah.
It's not the 2.5-yard line, but it's not much better as they mark it at the 9.
Brookwood have to do a better job of just maintaining possession, not going three and outs, going for short runs. They have to protect the sideline. They have to attack the sideline using the clock, making sure they move those chains. Spreading this defense around, that is key. You have to keep this defense honest.
Keelan, this far in your own territory, do you risk trying to throw the ball on a early down?
This is called the black zone. Black zone is a high potentially of deep balls, play action pass, things of that nature.
Left side this time, first carry of the night for the senior Demetrius Morgan, 5'9", 160 pounds. And at this point, Keelan, it looks like they're just trying to find a hot hand because they don't have one right now with Josh Brown out. And so Aubie came in and spelled Brown when he went down, and now you've got the senior Demetrius Morgan and Henry Fumura making another tackle, Keelan.
Yeah, those guys are hard to block up front. Demetrius Morgan trying to find a hole to get through the hole. But, hey, another senior defensive end who's going to Louisville, wrapping him up.
And that is the end of the third quarter. Hold up four fingers. We're holding them up in the booth, and they're holding them up down on the sideline. 12 more minutes of football here at the Corky Kell Classic. McEachern leads game 5, 24-3 over Brookwood. You're watching Georgia Public Broadcasting.
Sprint Turf, manufacturer of synthetic turf systems for sports like football, field hockey, baseball, and soccer. Sprint Turf synthetic turf systems are made in the USA and have been installed in more than 900 locations across North America. Sprint Turf provides sports field solutions for high schools, colleges, and professional sports teams worldwide. From recreational leagues to elite-level athletic programs.
I'm Mike Laverty, Regional Marketing Director for Metro PCS. We're proud to be the title sponsor of the Metro PCS Corky Kell Classic. It truly is the standard in high school football, like our nationwide 4G network is in wireless technology. Our partnership is just one of the many ways that Metro PCS gives back to the communities we serve. We appreciate your support and are thrilled that Georgia Public Broadcasting will be televising all these great games across the state of Georgia. Thank you.
Sometimes you get inspiration in the most unusual way. Enter GPB's video contest, win $1,000, and make a difference. How can you help stop the drop?
Of quarter, Georgia Dome, 12 minutes to go. McEachern leading Brookwood 24-3, and it's time, Grace, for the end of the trivia question.
It sure is. It is almost Sunday, almost 12 a.m. here at the Georgia Dome, but we are not going to forget to reveal our trivia question winner. The question for this final game of the day was which team, Brookwood or McEachern, was the first ever to play here in the Georgia Dome? Threw you for a loop on this one. What's the answer, John Nelson?
It's a trick question. They played each other, Brookwood and McEachern.
All right, so we have a throwback game going on right here tonight at the Dome and cap it off. Our winner is Ezekiel Koya. Thank you, Ezekiel, for answering very quickly on Twitter. Tweet me so I can get your information, send your GPB Sports Football on Friday's t-shirt. I will talk to you on Twitter. Thanks, everyone who participated. I'm going to send it back over to you guys in the booth.
Thanks, Grace. And during the break, we saw a halfback toss pass by junior Mason LeBlanc to the guy who's been serving as the punter so far tonight, senior Grant Hill. He makes a nice catch on the sideline, Keelan.
That's what I'm talking about, baby. You need a big play or something, baby. Just get the cobwebs out. Somebody wake up on that sideline over there, baby. Woke me up a little bit in here.
First down and 10, Brookwood, little breathing room here as they go to the sideline looking for Allen again, and it passes incomplete. And there you see Allen, who so far is the leading receiver for Brookwood. 3 catches, 37 yards. McLean, 6 of 17 for 82 yards. He doesn't get credit for the toss pass there. And the rushing statistics, not much different than they were when you recap them here at halftime.
Oh, man, they're making a living tonight. Brookwood, 43 yards. And McEachern is through the roof, over 200 yards in rushing tonight.
Most of those racked up in the first half of play. Brookwood's got 11 minutes and 29 seconds to do something, trailing 24-3. Haven't scored a point since their first possession of the game, and they try to get Keenan Sweeney, the tight end, involved. Pass falls incomplete as he's running a crossing route around the 50-yard line. That was a young man that caught a pass in the first drive, and they're just now getting him back into the offense.
You see Brookwood doing a little something different right now. This is exactly, he's open. All you have to do is just put it right there because he's wide open.
And McLean had time for a change as well. He's so used to 98 and 15 bearing down on him. So it'll bring up third down and long.
Coaches is calling their number. A player just had to make the play right now for Brookwood. They're calling the right plays for him on this drive. You just got to make the right play for him.
Brookwood continuing to come out with just two wide receivers in formation. Now they'll flex Keenan Sweeney, the tight end, out into the slot to the left. Two backs in the backfield. They'll both go out into routes. And there's 15 again. Henry Fromura pressuring McLean out of the pocket. He makes something out of nothing, but it'll be fourth down and long from the 40-yard line. And there's the Louisville commit, Henry Fromura. Boy, Louisville's getting themselves a good player, KJ.
Yes, they are getting a really good player. I really like how he just doesn't quit on the play. The left tackle, Matt Lee, just can't do anything with him. It's just a speed rush. He can't even get his hands on him, and that's what messes up the play. That's a good defensive end rush there.
Now Brookwood has to punt. One good play in that drive to get him up this far. The halfback toss pass, but it wasn't enough. Pressure on the punter, but it takes a Brookwood bounce. Roming takes it. Risky maneuver at the 15-yard line. He spins and jukes, trying to find some daylight, and does! And he's finally brought down at the 33-yard line. Can you tell by that run who's up 24-3? I think not. Roming still in it to win it. 45-yard punt and a nice return.
You talking about taking chances with a couple defenders in your place. It's just an athletic move, spinning 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 guys missed a tackle on that play. That is just an unbelievable play by TJ Roming. He's a speedster. He's their screen guy. And guess what? He loves to jump over people. That's what his coach told us in the meeting this
Kudos
week.
To number 20 for Brookwood, the senior Josiah Grant, who missed three tackles on that before finally bringing him down at the 33. Turn around, give Chubb up the middle. Not much doing. He falls ahead for 2 yards. And let's take a look at the quarterback's night tonight. Not particularly dominating through the air, but a very shifty guy, avoided a few sacks, and he's made some things happen with his feet.
Yeah, one thing we know about Clemens going into this ball game, his coach said he's going to keep the ball moving. He's going to keep plays alive. He's going to give his receivers chances to make plays down the field. He's going to give his running back chances to make plays down the field. And he definitely did that tonight in the Dome.
Of course, that nice TD run that you saw there. Some interest here from some big-time schools, Kentucky and the SEC, Louisville. Maybe he'll join Henry Fumura there.
You know what? Louisville is not a bad place for him. The type of offense that Charlie Strong runs for Louisville, he'll be a great fit for a backup quarterback because they definitely have a real good one. Tywater is his name.
We're about a week away from
Bridgewater.
With college football next week. So in just a few weeks, we'll have the trifecta. High school starts it, then college. UGA's got a big game against Clemson that I'm sure both of us will be watching. NFL kicks off in a couple weeks as we're here at the Georgia Dome expecting huge things from the Falcons this year.
Huge things from the Falcons.
Delay a game on the offense, 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
Let's not forget the game before the Falcons kick it off. You're going to have Virginia Tech and Alabama right here in the house. That's going to be an interesting game. You know, of course, you expect Bama to take that lead there. But I'm kind of concerned a little bit about this Clemson and Georgia game. Two strong offenses, not too sure what the defense is going to do on the defense side of the ball. Georgia lost 9 starters to the NFL on the defense side of the ball. It'll be an interesting college season for the Bulldogs.
You're not kidding. 9-11 to go here in the fifth and final game of the Kell Classic, 24-3. McEachern a comfortable lead, but they're still throwing the ball. And this one falls incomplete, intended for Malik Lewis. Lewis had to go up the ladder and try to bring this down and is unable to do so. Velocity-wise, the strongest throw on the night for Clemens. And there you see a close-up shot of Malik Williams.
Just a nice route across the middle, touches his hands. Price just couldn't get his hands on it. Couldn't bring it in. I think his gloves were a little bit too wet. It's been a long night for Price, man, trying to fight those battles and help his team in any way he can. But he's a great player. He's going to bring a lot to the table for the Brookwood on the defense side of the ball.
Yeah, a returning player from last year, returning starter at free safety, 79 total tackles last year, 4 picks, which led the team. Played all over the field last year, and as you said, they're going to count on him a lot. And Brookwood will have 2 guys back now. Looks like they're going to try to set up an intentional return here on the punt by Dennis Dominguez, and it is a very high punt. A fair catch is called for and not made again. Number 43, that's Patrick Mills, who's normally back to receive kickoffs, unable to handle the punt there. And Brookwood maintains possession, but barely. Second time that's happened tonight. And they almost lost possession.
Yeah, he just took his eyes off the ball. That's one thing you have to do. If you're a young kid and you're a Pop Warner player, high school player, you can't catch what you can't see. You can't catch what you can't see. That's the number one rule when catching a ball or filling the return.
Best field position by far the last 3 possessions for Brookwood. They've started at the 2, at the 9, and now here they start at the 39. But nothing doing on the first play as they continue to pound away with that running game. No gain on first down, and there's Billingsley getting up from the pile, number 98 for McEachern. Also number 90, senior Lucky Daniels, the defensive tackle, in on the stop.
As you hear over there, Brookwood band cranking it up over there, trying to get these guys some motivation to drive this ball down the field. It's a great atmosphere, man. Where would you rather be on a Saturday night? High school football, Trey.
In 11 minutes, it'll be technically Sunday morning.
Some of these kids are going to have curfew in a little bit. Streetlights came on.
Power eye formation, play action. There's Billingsley flushing McLean out of the pocket. He falls forward before Lucky Daniels rolls on top of him at the 43-yard line. A modest pickup of 4 yards on second down, and once again, Brookwood has third down.
It's a good heads up play by McLean. He's trying to get what he can get. Yeah, his throwing patterns was distracted by the defensive end all night, and he actually just gets to get him a 3 or 4 yard gain there. Hey, sometimes you have busted plays. You got to do what you got to do with your feet.
7:45 and counting. Keelan, if you're Brookwood, when do you even start to consider burning some of these timeouts? Right now, a 3 possession game. And a throw to the sideline, caught, taken down at the 42 yard line. Nice pitch and catch, and there's Allen again in the passing game with his 4th catch of the night.
That's a very nice pitch and catch right there by Mike Allen from your quarterback, Joy McLean. Coming in the window is a cover two coverage. His safety just played it over a little bit. No one put their hands on a receiver. It's very hard to stop a good receiver that has good hands if you're not going to put your hands on him. You have to put your hands on him in cover two to reroute the receiver. That time they did not do that. That's why they moved the chains.
Christian Wade making a nice tackle downfield. Passing play again. Nice, beautiful throw and caught by Grant Hill. Probably the best pass of the night for Joey McClain. It'll move the sticks and get the ball down to the 21-yard line for Brookwood.
As you can tell, that number two receiver coming across the middle on a skinny post. As number three clears the middle out for him, right up underneath him. Nice catch by Grant Hill, the senior receiver.
McClain is now 8 of 20 for 119 yards. Desperately trying to put some points on the board for Brookwood.
And as you can see, Brookwood are doing something they normally don't do. Now you have this defense on the heels. They game plan for heavy, jam-packed offense. Now they're
running
the ball.
Three-step drop in the shotgun. Lucky Daniels forcing him out of the pocket. And is eventually taken down. I believe that'll count as a sack because it's about a yard behind the line of scrimmage. Lucky Daniels is there. Number 99, Julian Rochester, is there. And they have been harassing Joey McClain all night long, Keelan.
Yeah, look at number 90, the big boy, Lucky Daniels, the nose tackle coming through there, giving the pressure on the quarterback, Joey. He falls down, but guess what? He gets back up and get him some on the tackle. I like that, big fella.
Second down and 11 for Brookwood. McClain now under center. Heavy, heavy package to the right side, and Billingsley forcing Aubie outside. Then two, three, four more blue shirts come in to dump him for a four-yard loss to bring up third down and very long, somewhere near the 27, 28-yard line.
I have an interesting quote by number 98, McKenzie, with quotations around it. And you know what it says? Plays hard. He's been all over the field. He doesn't quit. Heldman is off on the ground. He's still trying to get him some. He's still trying to get a little bit.
He get himself into trouble now because that is outlawed at the college and the high school level. Once a helmet comes off, that player is not allowed to re-engage in the play, and that's why you see him. He has to sit out of play now that his helmet comes off. So not in the game here on third down and long. McClain, shotgun, straight drop, look sideline again. Allen, that's their favorite route, their favorite receiver. First down, Brookwood, 10-yard line.
Nice throw with a little pressure on him. I'm telling you, Mike Allen runs some very crisp routes. If you take a picture, he's going to come in on the left side of your screen there. Watch it comes up. His hands are up. He's not catching the ball with his body. He's catching the ball with his hands, and he's getting a little yak after the catch.
Again, a very talented receiver who comes over from Central Gwinnett, a team that airs it out now. Central used to be known for a wing T team. They've got themselves a new head coach. The former OC from Gainesville is now in his second year at Central, and that's where they've gotten Mike Allen, and he's trying to fill Kai Priester's shoes and done a pretty good job as Brookwood moves into the region's red zone. And the pass intended again for Allen and falls just incomplete. Christian Wade on the coverage.
Just could have bring this one in as Joey rolls out to the right side of the field. I'm sure this is just a little flare out. He just couldn't hold on to the ball. He let the ball get to his shoulder pads.
Also, Ramoy Parsons breaking up the pass, number 31. Clock stops with the incompletion. 4:49 to go in the fourth quarter. McEachern up 24-3 on Brookwood. The sixth ranked team in the land so far, Keelan, has proven to be very worthy of that ranking, if not a lot more. And you know, one thing I did notice, Keelan, they've cleaned up the penalty situation here in the second half.
They really have cleaned up the penalty situation. I think they got a chewing out by both head coaches at halftime.
Demetrius Morgan plowing away somewhere near the 5-yard line when he emerges from the scrum.
If you're noticing, like I'm noticing the offensive linemen putting their hands on their knees right now in the middle of the huddle. Got the hands on the knees, got the hands on the hips. That's a good sign if you're Brookwood's OC. Obviously, you're doing something right. You're getting them out of the mode. You're getting them running. You're running some sprints out. So you're having your defensive lining running, making them tired. Like I said, that was one of the keys. Whoever gets tired first is going to win this game.
Demetrius Morgan goes in motion from the deep back. Rolling out to that side is McClain, looking, touchdown Brookwood, Matt Price. and Brookwood scoring their first touchdown of the game. 5-yard reception from Joy McLean to Matt Price, and Brookwood's on the board again, first time since their first possession of the game.
Mr. Dependable, he does it all for him. Third down receiver, new. Very high percentage pass right here. Gets you a really good touchdown. Price, I love his attitude right there. Give him a high five from his closest coaches. Trying to get a spark back on that sideline. He's doing a great job. He's playing his butt off today. Kudos to you, Matt Price.
One thing, Keelan, is whatever happens for the remainder of this football game, at least Brookwood's got some of their passing game on tape now as they go and study and prepare themselves for the remaining 9 games on their schedule.
Definitely.
We'll take a break. 3:59 to go in the fourth quarter. Still McEachern up comfortably over Brookwood by a score of 24-3. Don't go anywhere. Last few minutes of the Kell Classic coming up after this.
As the demand for power grows,
Georgia's nonprofit,
member-owned electric cooperatives
are committed to providing safe,
affordable,
and reliable electricity
to our members.
We've been dedicated
to building strong
communities
for more than 70 years
and are proud to join
the Georgia High School Association
and Georgia Public Broadcasting
in support of our state's student athletes.
We are Georgia EMC, lighting the way.
Welcome back to the Georgia Dome. Fourth quarter here, 3:59 to go in the game. McEachern up 24-10 on the Brookwood Broncos. And let's take a look at the night for one Mike Allen, the Central Gwinnett transfer. He's been their leading receiver and their go-to guy in the passing game.
He's been doing a great job tonight, man. Very nice body control. He's keeping those arms moving as he comes out his break. Good things happen to good receivers who run their routes and they finish it. He's just getting a little love because this defense is definitely not, they was not ready for tonight.
Now Brookwood looks like they'll go for the onside kick here. They really don't have a alternative, do they, Keelan?
Hey, I think it's what you have to lose, man. You know, you got exactly 4 minutes left to go. You got to try to get the ball back.
And he hits his player before it goes 10 yards. Hits the right hip of number 34, Chase Middleton, the normal middle linebacker who's lined up on the kick coverage team.
Look at this kick here. I guess you're just not paying attention. You got to keep your eyes on the ball. I know you're trying to go block, but you have to make sure you keep your eyes on the ball at the same time.
Spot of touching, first down.
Take a look at the TCSG scoring drive for the Brookwood Broncos. Keelan, 4 minutes, 55 seconds, time of possession. That's more like Brookwood football, but it may be a little bit too late with just 3:59 to go in the contest.
These 10 plays, 61 yards, 4 minutes and 55 seconds off the clock. Yeah, that's what you want to see. That's what you want to see. This is the Brookwood that we thought we was going to see coming into this football game, Trey. Obviously, something happened. I think the speed of McEachern's offense, the domination of McEachern's defense has just caught them off guard, and just when Brown went down, I think that took the life out of the team.
Keelan, a little surprised to see Taj Griffin carrying the ball. He's going to be your bell cow. You got 9 more games on your schedule. Game seems to be in hand here, 24-10. Although I will say you're only up by 14 points. I've seen stranger things happen. If you tuned into GPB a couple years ago when Buford played Calhoun, you'd have thought that Calhoun won that championship game. Buford comes back before Calhoun eventually wins it. So anything can happen here. But a little surprised to see Taj in the game.
I'm not too surprised, because I'm going to be honest with you here, Trey. You got to have him in there. I guess he gives you the best player on the field to make plays. And as long as you continue to keep moving the trains, bring him in and out. He doesn't have to be the featured guy right now, but because you have other guys in the backfield. You have other guys in the backfield, like Ryan, number 3. You have Chubb right there. You also have Ty. Great vision on this option. Ty decides to keep it and get upfield and keep the chains moving.
If you remember back in the second quarter, Ty Clemmons scored on that play from the other side of the field. And he does a nice job there of getting the end to bite. He finds the seam and picks up a McEachern first down, and that'll keep the clock rolling. Brookwood still with 3 timeouts. Trailing 24-10 up the middle. Sherman, he's got a touchdown tonight too, and he makes a nice run very, very close to another McEachern first down. He's eventually taken down by Matt Price, the Mr. Do-It-All for Brookwood so far tonight.
These backs are so good in the open field, Trey. I'm telling you right now, I'm very shocked to see Brookwood safeties and their cornerback making good open field tackles. That says a lot about their defense and how they prepare for this football game. Another first down for McEachern's offense.
Clemens over the 100-yard mark rushing tonight. 109 yards, 67 yards passing. He's lived up to the billing. The guy we spotlighted at the top of our broadcast is leading the McEachern Indians, and hopefully in 2 minutes and 15 seconds for Coach Hockman's sake, leading him to win number one of the 2013 campaign.
The good thing they're doing, they're keeping the ball between the lines and keeping the clock moving. Coaches just let them know, hey, continue to keep making first downs.
They see some substitutions as both Clemens and Ryan Sherman check out of the game, and now checking in at quarterback is freshman number 10, Bailey Hockman. If you recognize that name, that is the son of head coach Kyle Hockman, as he lines up in the pistol and gives it to Chubb up the middle, and Chubb knocking helmets off at the 15-yard line.
Right, Chubb, check him out. Nice, hard, aggressive run straight up the tap between the tackles.
Take a look now at our sprint turf play of the game. It's the 90-yard touchdown run by Taj Griffin.
This is probably the most impressive run by far this year I've seen. You're going to see how fast he is, how elusive he is, and how much fun he's having. It's all about attitude. It's all about speed for this McEachern's offense. They showed up and showed out today in the Dome, and this is a good game for them.
Alize Chubb up inside, picks up the first down, then drops the ball, and then away from the play, we're mixing it up in the backfield, and someone's having a 15-yard penalty throw on him. We'll have to wait and see who the official calls that. We have a couple players mixing it up back there, one of them being Brookwood linebacker Hobie McLean. So I believe they're going to call Chubb down before he fumbled. Now they'll have to assess who this 15-yard penalty is coming on. And the official scampers over to explain to Coach Kyle Hockman exactly what's going on. Minute 14 to go in this football game. Looks like McEachern's going to be able to pull it out 24-10. And let's take a look at the replay on the last play, Keelan.
All right. See what he got here. Nice lane in the middle.
Result of the play is a touchdown. After the score, we have a personal foul. Dead ball personal foul on the offense.
Yeah. So it looks like
touchdown counts. The penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
On the turf, his teammate recovered in the end zone.
And they call him touchdown.
And so they'll assess the 15-yard penalty on the kickoff, and it's 30-10 now, and Dominguez will come in and try to extend it to 31-10, and I think it's safe to say that McEachern is going to walk out of the Dome tonight with a victory.
And the extra point is good. And you see a nice run up the middle right there. Staying north, south. Chubb makes an aggressive move. Fumble there, and they recover the ball in the end zone. We'll be right back after these messages.
The Metro PCS Corky Kell Classic is made possible in part by Regions Bank. It's time to expect more. Georgia's Electric Membership Corporation, lighting the way. Technical College System of Georgia, learn more, earn more. And by viewers like you, thank you. Nothing prepares you better for a great career than the 25 colleges of the Technical College System of Georgia. TCSG colleges produce graduates with the knowledge and training today's top employers are looking for. With campuses across Georgia, state-of-the-art facilities, and outstanding instructors with real-world experience, it's the kind of affordable college education that will fast-track you into a rewarding career. We're building a better future for you. Contact the TCSG college in your area today or go to tcsg.edu.
Sports Medicine South, led by Dr. Gary Levengood, is an all-inclusive orthopedic surgery and sports medicine practice. We currently serve as the sports medicine provider for the GHSA and multiple teams across Gwinnett County. Sports Medicine South, Atlanta's sports medicine specialist.
The German Consulate in Atlanta, encouraging you to study German and to learn more about our diverse culture with much to discover in 2013. More information about Germany as an environmental leader and other current topics on the web at germany.info/Atlanta.
Each week, GPB brings you the latest in high school sports.
Hi again, everybody.
But we want to hear what you have to say. Tell us what's going on with your team. Share your favorite moments. Post your own pictures and videos. And let everyone know why your team will go all the way. Just log on and like us on Facebook, where you can post comments, pictures, and videos to earn your own team bragging rights. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter, too.
GPB, winner of 15 Emmy Awards. Thank you for your support.
To 10 as we await the remaining minute 14 of the fifth and final game of the Corky Kell Classic. Game well in hand for McEachern, 31-10. It's been all McEachern all the time as they just scored yet again. Uche and Cotty recovering a Elise Chubb fumble into the end zone, which extended the McEachern lead, and now they'll kick off. Mike Allen takes the ball at the 25-yard line and spins down at the 39-yard line.
I like the fight, Mike Allen. I have to just point that out. You can tell he still has some fight left in him. We have a minute and 7 seconds left in this football game. He definitely is not ready to go home, Trey. He wants to play some more football.
No, and that's the one thing about a loss for a team that has a history of winning. It leaves an awful sour taste in your mouth, and you can't wait for the next time to get between the white lines and redeem that feeling and get the feeling that you want to have as a Brookwood player or any of the other teams that lost today. Chattahoochee, Walton, Grayson, Camden County, all these teams are going to leave the Dome today with a bad taste in their mouth, and they're going to want to get back on the field as soon as they can and try to erase that feeling.
If you're a competitor, if you have any type of heart, if you have any type of motivation or willpower, you'll look yourself in the mirror and say, hey, what can I do today to make myself better for tomorrow?
Prior to snap, we have an illegal substitution on the defense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
And I think that's the greatest thing about sports. It builds character. And that's one thing when you have success, and when also when you have the down times in sports, you always have another opportunity to redeem yourself.
That's a great point, Keelan. Brookwood trying to muster something here in the remaining minute of the football game as they go outside to Dimitri Morgan. And they are going to give him the catch, yeah, Keelan, at the 35-yard line.
I thought he caught it as well. That's a nice catch, nice throw, nice route.
Goes out of bounds.
Morgan, the senior.
Stops the clock. Morgan checked into the game. It'll be a 26-yard catch for Morgan. He checked into the game.
Look at that. That's the catch
in the fourth
buddy.
Quarter. Obviously, Josh Brown goes out of the game. Aubie, who's playing both ways now, needs a break, so they've brought the senior in, and he's had a good showing here. Again, for the young man, a senior, not expected to start, it's good for him to get something on tape. We may see more of him as the season goes along for Brookwood because of this showing in the fourth quarter.
Exactly. I think they're running the same route on the wide side of the field.
Flag down.
Maybe a little pass interference there.
You're exactly right. Looks like this game is going to be bracketed by penalties. That's all we had in the first quarter. In the last two plays, we've had penalties as well. What a fitting way to end things here in game five for McEachern and Brookwood. A lot of mistakes to correct, and the body language says it all on the sideline for Coach Cruz in that last shot.
Oh, man. Don't want to be that team come Monday morning.
Doesn't look like Coach Cruz was very fond of the explanation that he was given after that last play, which was a legal man downfield.
I think he was looking for the pass interference.
We had a covered up receiver touch the ball downfield by rule. It's illegal touching. It's a 5-yard penalty. It's a loss of down. Second down.
So loss of down for Brookwood. That's the killer. And you could tell the look on Coach Cruz's face says it all. It was a you've got to be kidding me. When it rains, it pours.
Yes.
He's not had a good time here today, but rest assured that he is looking forward to getting in the film room, identifying the mistakes, and trying to get them corrected before Brookwood plays in their next game against Mill Creek on September 6th. They'll have a bye this next week. They play their last out-of-region game against Mill Creek, the team that knocked them out of the playoffs in 2 weeks. And another penalty flag, actually three of them on the field.
And it may be some good, it may be good news. Josh Brown,
prior to the snap, we have false start on the offense. 5-yard penalty, remains second down.
Josh Brown, not knowing, he said he doesn't know the status. The doctor is still evaluating his starting running back. He got a bye week next week. This is an opportunity maybe to get some rest, and he may get his starting running back in 2 weeks now.
Let's take a look at the penalty situation, which has been a huge story, although hasn't really affected the outcome of the game much, but sure has slowed down the momentum.
Yes, it sure has.
Here's Morgan after a nice catch, now makes a nice long run on the prevent defense down near the 31, 32-yard line. It'll pick up the penalty yardage and set Brookwood up on a third down play, as we're just about down inside of 30 seconds. Very, very early on Sunday morning. Let GPB be the first to tell you good morning, as it is 12-12 on Sunday here, as our coverage, which began at 9 o'clock this morning, is now in hour number 16, Keelan.
Yes, it is hour number 16. As you see the senior, Demetrius Morgan, carrying the rock there on the delayed draw, picking some yardage up. Huge third down coming up to see what they can do to convert it.
And Morgan again, and another flag. And the back judge throwing a flag with no time remaining in the football game. If it's a defensive penalty, we'll see one more play. If it's on the offense, that'll end this football game. Very fitting way. As the clock
holding
down
on the offense, penalties declined, the game is over.
And that'll end the game. Game five in the books. McEachern wins it 31-10, and John Nelson is standing by with Coach Kyle Hockman. Nelly.
Thank you, Trey. Good morning, Coach. Dominating performance.
I need some breakfast. I want to give credit to Jesus and our players, good players. We just got to clean up some stuff. And again, like I mentioned before, 27 penalties, I think, was there. Obviously, it was kind of ugly. First game for the officials, too. But, Taj and Ty, great job. Our defense played their butt off. They had a couple, big plays that got them some field position. But just real excited about getting ready to play again here in a few hours next week.
I was going to say, you got a few hours to prepare. Go prepare. Congratulations, and thanks for hanging out with us until Sunday.
We love you guys. Thanks for the opportunity.
Appreciate it. Send it back upstairs. The beach is closed, Trey and Key. Let's go home.
John, everyone, it's been a wonderful day of action here, Keelan.
Yes.
Five games are in the books, and we've only just begun. We've got several more weeks of action on Football Fridays. Next week, we'll be live at Grayson High School as they take on North Gwinnett. North Gwinnett winning today, Grayson losing. Both teams started the season in the top 10. Grayson may still be there after losing to the second-ranked Tool, a team in the state. Just talk about this experience for these young men and what it had to mean, win, lose, or draw, to play in the Georgia Dome as a senior.
Oh, come on. I had the opportunity to play in this Georgia Dome numerous of times, but every time it's just mind-boggling. It's a great atmosphere. These kids do not know what they're getting in. The Colquitt County came up. Some of these guys never been to the city of Atlanta. Never been to the city of Atlanta. This is a one-in-a-lifetime opportunity. It's a blessing to play on the big stage where former NFLers and Pro Bowlers walk these halls and played on this grass and this field turf. So it's an unbelievable, humbling experience for everybody.
Well, we're unbelievably grateful for those of you that stuck with us for all 15 some odd hours. Good morning and so long from the Georgia Dome.